so forth.
Okay. Okay. So the stream is starting. I believe we got a glimpse of MatPat for a second before this appeared. So, hello everybody. Welcome to Destruction Bench Agreement. What a great start to the session. The beginnings of these sessions have only been getting better. What did the last one start with? Monkey noises?
Now we have a real monkey.
Yeah, now we have an actual monkey.
Yeah.
So yeah, if you guys are new here, this is Destruction Bench Agreement, a thing we do weekly that's like a PvP and sometimes not tournament kind of a...
One time's not.
In the anime campaign.
To make it full PvE at some point.
Yeah.
Maybe someday.
Yeah, maybe someday, but it's in the anime campaign rule set, if you know what that is. And yeah, if you do know what that is, I think you know that we're going to have a good time, especially if you've seen an episode of DBA before. So before we start off, I would like to, as I always do, go through the people that are here, introduce their characters, and if like what they're doing here, if they have a... another sort of role. So, as I pull up my Discord to read everybody off, starting from the top, we got Ballast.
Hello, I am Ballast, and I am the GM this week. It's going to be a kind of a simple gimmick, but it'll be a fun one, hopefully.
up next on the list, we got Diglett.
I'm surprised I'm not first this time.
First girl.
I'm Diglett, and I'll be playing Mr. Dad.
It's been a while, hasn't it?
Yes.
up next on the list is, unfortunately, Dream with his character.
I'm Dream, the resident galactic asshole. I've been promoted, and today I'll be playing a character making a comeback from Banana Slamma, Big Kong.
Yeah, if you've seen
this can only end poorly.
Ultimate technique.
I hope you guys
because...
are ready for pits.
Alright.
Man, this match is gonna be the pits, am I right?
Bump, bump.
Yeah, up next on the list is Elthanas.
Hey, I'm the one playing the totally not insane cultist girl.
That was a really good laugh, holy crap.
Yeah, but let me tell you, and by the way, just in case, if you couldn't tell just based off art style, I drew that icon, so I'm happy.
Wow. Thank you, by the way.
Nice. No problem.
Thank you for drawing it.
Oh yeah, no problem. Hey, I had a blast.
Four of the six icons for this match were drawn by us.
Yeah, I was thinking about that today, actually. Up next on the list, we got Gecko.
Hello, I'm Gecko. I'm gonna be playing Chip. As an announcer and Codium, so.
Hey. Nice. Up next.
That reminds me, I gotta get another dock open as well.
Up next is Moomin Man.
Another dock.
Hi, wait, I'm Moomin.
Got one.
I'm going to be playing Ortonian Corvi. He's the reincarnation of Otto the Great. No one knows who that is because no one knows history.
Well. Moomin may need to be upped. Well, I have Moomin at the max volume that I could possibly have him, so...
I can speak louder. I was just being a bit quiet.
Have me louder, or...
I think you're good, Ballast.
Okay, Sylvia said to help me a bit is what I was asking as well.
Yeah. Alright. Then, up next on the list is me. Today, I'm playing as, Lobster Boy Emmerich Ranova! He was player character in last week's PvE session. He was announcer of the session before that, and at this point, he's managed to make himself a meme in yet another campaign, so I'm very happy with that. And
again, Emmerich Ralevar, title in every campaign other than his own.
Yep. up next...
He's like a homeless.
Yeah, pretty much. up next, we got Sylvia, who's, I think she's just chat goblining. So yeah, we'll move on then. after that, we got Yum Yum Bits, or Yum Yums, Yum, whatever.
Whichever. Yeah. Any of them work, really. Hello, I'm Yum Yum Bits, and today I'll be playing the one character that was drawn by me, instead of Austin, Jamie.
Nice. Yeah, she was in the Pokemon match where Her Lucario got married to Alan, I think it was, before Alan was sent to hell, so that was pretty fun.
Yeah, Jamie prefers not to think about that match that much.
And then,
Lucario is still in therapy.
Yeah. And then, last but not least, as always,
I don't know about you guys, but I thought it was a pretty good match.
Last but not least, as per usual, because his username begins with a Z, we got Zanza as our resident chat goblin along with Sylvia. I don't know if he wants to say anything, but...
I am here. I'm always watching.
Hello.
That's all.
As well.
Alrighty.
Cool. Intros are out. I'm going to move y'all to the page. And remember, blue is Emmerich... Dad and Ryla, red is Otto, Big Kong.
Let's all just put the little color circle on our icons.
Oh yeah.
I'll do that once I get Emmerich on screen.
I've already done it.
Oh okay, cool, cool. Nice.
You put on the combat theme or the intro theme.
Oh they blew.
I like the name I came up with that. Okay. So
what?
I was just talking to myself basically. Okay. Hi there, folks. You might remember me from a previous match. The name's Charlie Betts. I was gone for a while getting surgery and getting used to... And... Anyway, me and Chip here, he motions to Chip.
Hey!
Was for tonight. Now, I'm going to address an elephant in the room. Yes, this is the 13th match. Not a great omen. Competence of not having luck professionals last match, we've managed to scrounge something together that will appease the hands of fate.
Don't worry, I made sure it's fun enough.
Enough about that, we've got contestants to introduce. Let's start with blue team. Cards. Here's that we don't have notes on everybody, so, Emmerich. Come on down, Mr. Emmerich.
Emmerich just looks around. Oh!
I like his name!
He has another special... He has an interesting hand too, doesn't he, Chip?
Well, he looks like a lobster.
He sure does.
A lobster's lucky.
Oh, I'm not really much into that. Hopefully he does have some luck, because it's important on today. And...
We'll see,
following
I guess.
This, man, we have... Oh, it's my father, Mr. Dad.
Wow, he's my father too!
It's weird. I didn't know we were brotherships. I mean, I knew we were a lot alike, but I didn't know we were brothers.
Awesome.
The more you know. And lastly, we have on blue team, Ryla.
That's a cool name.
Well, oh, this can only end well.
What about you, Seema? I like your attitude.
Hopefully this isn't going to allow that to happen. I don't care. This tournament has terrible safety standards. That's how I lost my hand. I'm just not going to comment on that.
That's what makes hands could
be useful later.
Comment too.
Let's move on.
And on to red team, the first member, we have a Jamie Jolt, also known as JJ.
Karate
get up. Maybe she has some interesting moves prepared for us today.
Well, everyone's scared, she might just kick.
Next we have... This is an interesting name. Big Kong?
Is that a monkey?
A monkey.
Is this an animal fight?
He's smoking a banana cigarette.
Nice cigarette, I guess. Let's move on.
Next on the red, we have Autonian Corvée.
Kid?
Well, I mean, that Jamie girl is a kid too, so...
Oh, you're right.
Anyway, well, now that we've introduced everybody, might as well continue talking about ourselves. I am Charlie Betts. I am a professional gambler, and Chip here is also a gambler.
Technically. And
yes. So, as we said, today is not a lucky day, so we've decided, hey, test your luck if you want, and he points to the slot machines that were in the last round that are now in the corners. Just stop by there and pull the lever, and you'll see what happens.
Test your luck. See what happens.
And I will say this in advance before anyone gets up there and actually asks. It will take a full round action to pull down the lever unless you like mess with it for some reason to make it do less or so. And with that out of the way, roll initiatato.
Oh boy!
Initiatato? That's my favorite vegetable.
Oh wow.
Oh.
Music's dead. I guess Jamie's... She was busy swapping out her new icon.
Wow. I'm very curious to see how these slot machines differ from the ones in, like, the last match.
Yeah.
They will actually be used. That's the one way they'll be different.
I mean...
Yeah, but, you know.
Con, I've added you to the turn. Okay, so yeah, just make sure you put in your initiatives.
Yeah, Dream, just... Yeah, there you go.
Sending... So, Otto, first up.
Well, obviously, there's a lot for me to do here, so...
Right, first up is Otto. What's he gonna do? Let's see.
Okay, so you pulled down on the machine?
All my movement. So... Actually, no, I double moved.
Okay, well then, never mind. Big Kong.
Well, Big Kong is gonna do what he does best, and he's gonna start placing down pits for the rest of the match.
Where is this first pit going to be?
Right there.
Here we go.
Post it now. Had a post-it.
Yeah, I put it in your character sheet, so I don't know if it's been updated.
Oh, that's right, I'm sorry.
Just do it, you gotta roll for it.
Yeah.
Sorry. Hold on, my mouse. Ah! As soon as it's the enemy's turn, I'm gonna get some batteries for this thing.
This time on DBA,
I have to replace my...
Completely, suddenly, without any explanation, naked ape can summon an extremely deep hole in any space within 3 feet of where he's standing. Any unit who somehow manages to fall down this velocity is the largest ladder possible to try and escape. This is no easy feat, as it will take said unit's movement action to get up, along with standard action on a high roll.
Alright, so now you gotta roll.
Give us the roll.
Okay.
Oh, come the fuck
yes!
on!
Oh,
okay.
Get his theme!
Alright,
I think that should take up... of the 2x2, then.
I'm working on it.
Or it can be double deep.
Falls into that is going to have their entire turn taken up by it.
Immediately, like, oh god, this...
That's just plus make a
one. That's plus one proficiency.
Oh my god.
Where did that
it's
come
not proficiency,
from?
It's just PvP, remember?
Yeah,
it's stamina cost.
The first turn.
The first turn. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
I will be the end of your turn. So
I'm gonna go
get a hole and then walk up to the right.
I'm gonna go
what
get some batteries
turn.
Now.
Okay, it is Emmerich's turn. I don't have a plan necessarily. Emmerich turns to Mr. Dad and Ryla. Okay. So,
what is with that monkey?
So, these slot machines are giving me memories of last week's encounter. However, I am sure that the establishment here has worked it out and we shall not be attacked by more glitch robot monsters. So,
Yeah, no, oh, because the look professionals are here, don't worry about it. I almost lost my other hand with those things last week.
I reinforced the door! It should last for another week at most.
Alright. Yeah, Emmerich facing Mr. Dad and Ryla. Now, I've been told that I am fairly lucky, so I feel as if I should perhaps try pulling on these slot machines. Would you two like to join me, or would you rather handle the enemy?
I can do both, perhaps.
I'll give you cover.
Alright. Sounds like a good plan. I'm putting my faith in both of you. And with that, I guess this one's closer. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm a double move. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, he's moving five. To the slot machine.
Yeah. As close as I can get, so. Yeah, that's about all I'm working
to. Mr. Dad.
Alright, let's start off day with Dad on Emmerich.
Hey, I knew this was gonna happen!
Yeah.
Oh my god.
I need to remember exactly what day with Dad does, but if it's what I'm remembering...
Oh, sure, I'll just Tell post him. It.
Okay. Yeah, whenever entering exit, or exit conversation... Yeah, okay. His current talent. Yeah, that's what I thought.
Yeah.
Okay.
And yeah, I was getting Jamie blocking position.
Okay, if that is your turn, Jamie.
Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
I turn with a working mouse.
Nice.
Okay, so don't even have double movement.
That was not actually.
God, you have 8? Oh, I forgot that. I forgot you have post your talent. You take your full action to do the thing?
Yeah. So, should I roll a d20?
Oh, well, pull it down. And you rolled a 7.
You roll a 7.
Oh!
Oh.
Oh.
Wow! Charlie. It's a nat 7! Wow!
Okay, so he took. Oh. He looks at Jamie. Give me a call. Heads or tails? He takes out one of Chip's compound coins.
I'll go with heads.
Heads will be Charlie. Tail. Okay, so. I'm afraid that is an incorrect call. Nothing happens.
Oh.
Sorry, kid. Okay. Better luck next time.
This is the gimmick. If you roll a 7, something might happen if you call the coin toss right, because it's double luck.
Uh-oh.
And as Jamie, as you do that, you see there's only one slot on this machine, and it has 1 7, so this machine is now finished.
Ah, okay.
So Lila, I'm guessing, yeah.
Yes.
Well, there's no way that I'm going to be able to reach that machine. There's no way that I'm going to be able to reach the machine quickly. Yeah. I'll start by moving myself over here. Well, a little random for now. Just a tad. It'll be useful later.
Okay, post the ability or whatever.
There's the ability.
Yeah, this is my favorite ability name in the entire TBA.
Alright!
Surprised!
Surprised people that will help us later!
Okay, so...
Don't ask about the whiskey flask that she suddenly pulled out. She'll need it.
Pull out a whiskey
Drinking
flask.
In the match?
What else
flask
of
whiskey.
What else are you going to do?
I don't know. I think MatPat's kind of a tool.
Okay, right. So that does not
keyword,
action, so
small object here.
Else.
I can't... that flat would be way too big for me to pull out right now.
You're right, his ego's
Thank
too
God.
Large.
Elfanus is still having another action because this doesn't use an action.
Yep.
Bring out a baby.
Yep, I'm gonna double
I've come here to kick ass and destroy MatPat on screen.
Yeah, I'm gonna double move over to the slot... I keep misclicking. There we go. This will work, hopefully.
That is first round of combat. Otto, your turn.
All right, let's see what happens when I pull this lever. What do I need to do for this? Just roll?
No, I got you.
All right.
You roll a 7.
Oh, okay. Who would've guessed?
I think you're rolling a 7.
Yeah, you're not rolling a 1d7.
No,
you're
this is the point.
Okay, so give me a second while I add that to Chip's, to Charlie's count. Okay, so Otto, heads or tails?
I'll take the tails. It's my favorite Sonic card.
Let's see. That is not it, but because you're the second person, you get another call. Heads or tails again.
Oh, that's rigged.
I'll go tails again.
Actually, I don't know why I'm complaining. Otto's on my team, so.
Damn. I mean, you need to drop a JJ.
Don't hit anything again.
So why are we trusting the casino guy to set up the fucking slot machines, to be fair?
An action movie, though.
Is this just powering you up somehow?
Oh, yes, but if you do call the coin correctly, you do get something. So, Otto, you can now take a movement since you're already there, right?
In this slot.
Don't forget, guys, with the bad luck comes the good, so.
This slot is also taken up now, so the bottom two are now used.
Well.
Ooh, I wish. So, your turn, Big Kong, your turn again.
Oh, boy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I'm gonna end my turn.
Wow, that's a big Kong.
That is a big Kong.
Are you going to not? Are you just gonna prepare an action or something?
You know what? Yeah, we'll just make this area the pit field. Put a pit there.
Wow. With this monkey on their team, the other team is in a whole lot of trouble.
right there.
That's going to just be a movement pit. Give me a second while I put it. Okay, no, Gecko got me. Okay, so the one beneath you is going to be a movement action pit. So okay.
Boy.
You get to take Lost and Emmerich.
Keeping in tradition with Emmerich's luck, he's about to get that third 7. So he's gonna walk up and now I'm wouldn't consider myself a gambling man, but let's take a swing. And he's going to pull down on the thing.
So you roll a 7.
I can't believe
you
got a 7.
Okay.
Alright, so oh Colin, heads or tails?
Wow, is it really a 7? I'm totally surprised.
Yeah, Emmerich looks down at his lobster tail. I'm gonna go with tails.
Hey,
I got it!
He caught the bit!
Oh, you recover 3 stamina. Since you're at full, it will be 3 temp hit points.
Ooh.
Oh.
There's 2 things that have not been taken yet. Call heads or tails again.
Oh! Well, tails worked good the first time, so I'll go with it again.
It's not rigged. Trust me. This is rigged.
So,
it's not rigged.
I'm getting the distinct feeling it's rigged.
You can now deal 3 damage to 1 enemy of your choice.
This is rigged!
Emmerich looks around at his opposition. I'm getting the feeling I've met that monkey before, and I'm getting
this
the feeling
rigged!
That I should deal with him as quickly as possible. So, Big Kong.
Big Kong, you take 3 damage.
This is rigged.
I have to say, Emmerich.
Yes?
Unlocked. Heads or tails?
Now, tails has worked Emmerich. Twice. However, I have a good feeling that heads will be the one this time. Yes!
Oh, fuck you. Emmerich!
You shouldn't have brought Emmerich to the luck battle!
This is rigged because the enemy team has Emmerich!
So first off, you have a saved plus 7.
Ooh.
Second off, you hit a jackpot!
Oh, yes!
Oh my
3
god.
3 plus 7s, and you get another 6 temp HP, and you can deal 3 damage twice to 2 enemies again.
What? This is not okay!
Alright, so 3 plus 7s. Alright.
This guy's so lucky.
Oh my god.
Man, I am quite glad we don't have to play against him.
I get another 6. Okay, and then I get to deal
three damage, two
here,
more.
Here, Austin. Let me just do it for you.
No, you go back in there because Emric, looking at Big Kong, well, as much as I am getting a threat from that Big Kong figure, it would be good to get even spread. So 1-3 to Jamie and 1 to Otto.
Otto and Jamie, you each take 3 damage.
This entire battle is rigged against us.
Oh, I'm so glad I brought Emric.
Why did you allow him to play as Emric for this?
Because I wanted to see, if it would apply to D2s as well as D20s, to be honest.
It's Emric, of course it is!
somehow I feel like I'm being punished for someone else having good luck.
Yeah, alright, I'm done, that's it. Emric wins.
Alright.
Oh, and also
this
I have to say,
the plus 7 match is rigged against us!
Only apply to Emric, so you can't use them for your allies.
Okay,
well, moving back over. Let's make this a little bit smarter.
Well, that was pretty, interesting.
I honestly didn't expect the jackpot to be used that early.
Yeah, I don't know. That guy just has insane luck.
Oh, Jamie, okay. Your turn.
Looks like Mr. Dad's making a break for the other vending machine. I mean,
So everybody knows there is only one more thing active, and that's the one Ryle is next to. Turn.
All right. So.
Oh god, I'm not gonna make the same mistake that I need. Help me. I'm just gonna hold an action to kick if anybody walks up next to me.
Hello, your turn.
Wow, I was not planning on activating this early at all.
Oh boy, do we get to see it happen?
God damn, roll 2!
Yeah, you take off your eye patch, and nothing happens.
Crap!
Don't worry, I'm sure you'll get it next time.
Ooh.
Okay.
Nice.
And I'm gonna
Mr. Dad,
okay,
so,
if I can.
Comforting words.
Okay, so...
Comforting words.
Okay, that was the wrong building.
Oh, so...
What were you doing?
Okay, I was meaning to roll if it's worth doing, then it's worth doing again the first time.
Hey.
And then the second one was to try to copy
Ryla,
that 19.
Yeah,
Ryla
can try
it. Ryla, you can re-roll your attack. Oh, yeah. Or your ability, right. Whatever.
Oh, I really hope we get to see this, because, oh boy.
Hey, what's happening?
Okay, so yeah, that'll work.
There's two ones!
Well, there's two of them! Yes, now I have to, I don't know how to summon the other one exactly with you, yeah. Using this, but...
It's next turn that you, I think.
Yeah.
Okay, so about this, I've been meaning to ask you, does it create a copy of you, or is it just you get a second action?
It's intended to be a second player, if she's there twice.
Yeah, and like one of them is the one with both purple eyes and one is the one with both green eyes.
So give me a second while I do that. And Sylvia, since that was what you were wanting to do.
Wow, sis, you must be really desperate if you came to my aid this early.
Well, let's just say if we both pull this down simultaneously, we're guaranteed to get it right.
Oh no.
I mean, there's only one thing for it to happen. Yeah.
I was planning on dual-teching with myself here.
So give me a second. Sylvia, do you have control of the second, Ryla?
Sorry.
While I apply your staminas.
They both get reduced by half.
Yeah.
Did she just turn into two people? But take your eye patch off.
So, Island number 2, are you going to be pulling the lever?
We should dual tech with ourselves to make it so that we can both grab it down and basically both heads and tails and guaranteed to get it right. That made no sense, but hey.
First off, you can pull down the only one per. You can pull down the lever, and then you can both call it. But
that's
first,
the
you
point.
Have to technically pull the lever. So, are you going to pull the lever?
I'm guessing it's Sylvie.
I'd say yes. There's two of us, and if we both
second,
pull it, that would both. Technically, since there's two of us, that'd be applying two people. Technically, since there's two of us, it'd be applying two people. So therefore, it'd be half the strength required, likely taking less.
One Ryla used their main action to summon the second Ryla, which means that first Ryla has no more action.
Yeah, so the one Sylvie is controlling has to choose. Yeah.
Do you choose to pull the lever?
I'm gonna pull the lever, Mr. Charlie.
Okay, so you pull. So you rolled a seven.
Also, Sylvia, you're like the most quiet you've ever been.
Okay, let's try this.
There you
let's
go.
See if that helps.
That's a little better.
Ryla and Ryla, heads or tails?
Which one do you choose?
We should go opposites, therefore we're guaranteed to get it. Therefore one of us is guaranteed
but
to get it right.
Fun, which one is going to call which is what I was
tails.
Asking.
I called tails.
I'll do heads then.
Okay, so the second Ryla, let me see what that one is. You have an saved advantage on a roll of your choosing, of yours.
Which one does? I'm confused. This always confuses me.
So they have
and Ryla.
So they have two characters that can guarantee winning the coin flip.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's... Monkey man.
This sure does seem a little unfair, actually.
This is like all jokes aside. This is completely rigged. Like 100%.
Do the Ryla's want to take move actions?
Didn't you say I was out of action, anyways?
Out of primary action, you can still move.
Well. Featuring Dante from the Devil May Cry series.
Like, you really should have put either Ryla or Empress.
Wait a second. Would this technically imply that Dante would be here now?
We're not bringing Dante in here. Are we?
Damn it! That would have been perfect.
You should have put either Ryla and Emmerich on opposite teams. That would have been not rigged.
Yeah.
But this is completely 100% rigged against us. Like, all
fine, Mr.
No, it's fine.
I asked if any of you had any certain ideas of teams, and you didn't say.
That's your fault.
We only found about the gimmick now.
I said to Zanza that I need Charlie's icon. You should have assumed that something luck-based was going to happen.
Regardless. What's happened has happened. We gotta move on.
It's regardless. Yeah.
You had bad luck for the comp. So, Otto, your turn.
Okay. No, I'm just gonna hurt that one, and I'm gonna hit and Ryla with a floor plan to smash her into the slot machine.
Ow. That's rude.
No, fuck.
Hey.
Since that's not a crit fail, I'm not going to say that you fill up one of Big Kong's holes, but nothing happens. So, wait, have you used your movement yet, or no?
No, I'm... hello.
Looks like red team's having a hard time.
Yeah,
well,
you completely weighted everything against us!
Big Kong, your turn.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
I'm in range. I'm putting the vending machine in a fucking pit.
Okay.
I wonder what the monkey's doing.
Only had one use, so if you do that, you're wasting your action.
All right, which Ryla has advantage?
Both tails, which I believe
it was green.
That's
me
and Ryla.
It's and Ryla.
She's going in the fucking pit.
And Ryla.
Okay.
I thought
that was almost 20.
Okay.
I don't know.
Just within three spaces.
She's 4.
Yeah, technically, and Ryla is 4.
Wait, summon it next to Ryla.
That this 3 spaces is not technically a feet measurement.
Oh, okay.
I grab the thing for that. Plus, they're in a bad position. They need the little bonus.
Understandable.
I don't know.
Sylvia, you got quiet again.
I'm confused.
Okay, so yeah. Sylvia's Ryla will have to use their movement action to get out of the pit on their turn.
I can't whistle.
No!
Emre.
You're next!
Alright, Emmerich looks over to Mr. Dad. Mr. Dad, do you have a handle over Big Kong with Ryla?
I got it.
Alright, I'll handle Jamie. Yes, that was her name. Emmerich is going to, well, for now,
from,
yeah?
From, sorry, from the fit you hear, which one of us?
now let's see. One, two, three, four, five, and... Do I want to use it now, or do I save it? Because I could use the move now, but I don't think it's time yet. So, Emmerich's just gonna, like, he's gonna cross his arms as his cape, flaps majestically at the wind, and he stares down Jamie. Come at me, Jamie! We shall have an honorable duel!
All right.
You do have another action. You have an action.
All right, I can double move! One, two, three... this is a good stare down distance.
Seeing if you would actually move close enough for the trigger of the attack that Jamie had prepared.
No, I like stare down distance better.
Jamie's just staring you down like, come closer.
They're staring at each
other. Mr. Dad, your turn.
Let's see. Oh, that might hurt her.
I'm okay with being hurt.
It's gonna lead well.
Do it.
Well, let's try something interesting with a change of floor plan. Nope. Ooh,
nope.
God.
No one can get it right.
He copied the ability from the previous round and recreated it with the two.
True.
Oh, I did?
Okay. Yeah, because Ryla had two last time.
Yeah, I was going to try to pop out Ryla with it and then knock her toward Big Kong. Yeah.
No, it has the ability to push people. Like, it has the ability to launch people into the air.
Yeah.
But what he was saying is basically he's going to make floor underneath the pit raise up instead.
Yeah, using Otto's ability, I say.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nothing happens.
Not damaging her.
Alright, well, if you're not gonna come to me, then I guess I'm just gonna have to go to you.
Yes! Show me what you've got!
God damn it. God damn it.
With the bad luck, I'll say you can get a grazing hit.
Yeah.
Damage.
That's fine.
Alright.
So how much is it?
I'll say it's five.
Five.
Just
okay.
Like all betting rings, this match is so staged it hurts.
Emmerich like takes the hit and it like scrapes against him and like he as he gets hit he feels the pain but like some weird. I cut out right yet. Yeah, some weird lucky aura seems to protect him very slightly. Ah yes, great technique.
Man.
But I'm sure I could do better.
Man, I'm not at the top of my game today.
Do you have any movement left that you want to use, or passive or whatever allows you to do that?
I'm just gonna leave it at that. My passive's technically only supposed to apply to my basic attack, so.
Ryla, your turn.
I'm guessing
Anne. Wow, looks like you're stuck down there.
Yeah, I'm guessing Anne Ryla uses her turn to get
out.
Yeah,
Anne Ryla only has a action. He cannot move unless she uses her action to double move, technically speaking.
Can she be like here or is she above the pit still?
It's getting out of the pit, so you're right there.
That was the monkey's fault, right?
Yep.
Can we murder him?
Yes.
All right, sweet.
Emmerich looks over.
That monkey will be very useful.
You really shouldn't kill animals.
What do I care? Let's see. To start with, I'm gonna pull out a little something. A surprise tool, perhaps. Duct tape. As much duct tape
won't.
As I can.
No, you won't.
Well, either way, I'm gonna force feed the whiskey to the monkey. Trying to get it drunk to ruin its accuracy. Taste it.
Okay, never mind.
Again! Taste it!
So
I'm gonna force feed the whiskey.
Yeah, I'm guessing Ryla
to decrease the monkey's accuracy to down to shit.
I'm guessing, yeah, Ryla has to roll, right?
Roll for that, and Big Kong will probably get, yeah, because it's a very telegraphed thing, and he is a banana-smoking man, and Big Kong can roll against this.
Okay.
Yeah, if Banana Slim has anything to say, he knows alcohol.
Tasty! Damn!
Okay, so you don't get that to happen, but Big Kong, as you roll that, Chip... Mine's doing your thing since you rolled a 13.
Oh no.
Oh no.
It really is team bad luck.
Oh.
This match is so fucking rigged, it's ridiculous.
You can't possibly not get the bad effect. Okay, Gecko.
Gecko?
Gecko!
Oh, I was muted!
Okay. Ah, Chip, rip!
Chip says, like, tearing duct tape over his mouth. okay.
Well, that's where the duct tape went!
Sorry! I don't know how that happened. Alright, call heads or tails. With the good luck comes the bad.
I'm guessing it's Big Kong.
The monkey?
Yeah, the monkey. Big Kong is calling the toss.
Let's go with heads!
Okay. It's tails.
Okay. You called it wrong. You do get the first bad effect. You lose 3 stamina.
Oh, God.
Team bad luck.
I'm already at half health.
Jesus.
No, it's even
God, I almost feel bad for these guys. It's.
I'm supposed to be doing something.
Yeah, Riley.
You have an action.
Yeah, and Ryla
has
an action.
Sis? What do
you think
we need?
Wow!
Not a good idea, but,
I can guarantee you this match is not fun or funny for those of us on the red team.
I'm sorry.
Just tell it to me psychically. DM it to me. Just psychically communicate it with me. DM.
Quickly.
They're like staring at each other like they're talking. It's weird.
They're staring each other down.
Yeah, they're staring each other down.
Oh, yes! We do still have that! Do
okay,
it.
I'm going to take out a surprise tool that will help us later. A gyrozapelli ball.
No.
The same one from earlier!
Is that okay, GM?
Roll that what?
It's a steel ball, like JoJo.
What was this about earlier?
Back in the locker room!
I wasn't
long
meaning
story.
For that.
Long roll story.
Did you use infinite spin on that?
Roll for it, yes.
That's an 11.
Because of the bad luck, you get a steel ball, but it's not like a full steel ball.
Yeah.
Wait, where's the one that we had 5 seconds ago? Well, like half an hour ago, go!
We split into two, you might have it.
I might have half of it.
Do you have half of one?
I have a regular steel ball. It's just like a steel ball.
Well, that can still be used for a lot of things.
Really not an action, so you do
what
have
the hell happened to
us? Don't worry, I something messed up, so I was fixing it. There we go.
Alright.
Okay. And Ryla technically has
a Ryla, you do have another action.
Hmm?
What?
Because the
because that doesn't use an action.
Oh, sweet. Can I throw the steel ball at Big Kong?
You could save it for later bullshit, though.
Here's the thing, we can probably pick it up when I throw it at Big Kong.
Both of you have used
fully blind.
Both of you have already used an action.
Well no, but the thing is, and Ryla, because she used it's a surprise tool, that doesn't count as an action, so she has another one.
Wow. This is intended
If you try to hit Big Kong, it will require a high roll because God, your team is so stacked against this one. What happens when you pit kids and a monkey against?
You know what I'm gonna do? Go
Sylvia, can you speak up a little bit? What are you doing?
You don't have a movement action.
Yeah, you can.
Double moving. Double moving is, I think.
Oh, okay. Oh. Yeah.
Two. Okay. Three. That's all I can move.
So, your turn.
Okay. One, two, three, four, five. Would you like perhaps a bit of
you
healing?
Once tried to...
I couldn't hear you over her.
Yes. What the fuck happened to my accent? I'm just gonna try and heal you up.
Please!
Okay, so I'll say that heals for 4 stamina, yeah.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah, no, honestly, like, give it to him.
Thank you,
give it
God.
To him.
I was already at half health on the second turn!
Oh, God, man.
This is a good match.
No, it is not.
Yeah. This is interesting.
This was,
Good. Big Con doesn't even have, like, bad
I don't know
stamina
why
either.
Y'all went over to their side when you have
yeah,
good
no, he has. Shit. He starts out with 39 stamina. He's got good shit.
Death pit on your side. Why did you go over to them?
I'm going to try to judo throw Ryla into the pit.
Oh, no.
Oh, boy.
CQC!
Oh, no.
Yes.
Oh, CQC! Yes.
Nice. High roll. I will say it takes up both your actions to get back out.
Does it? How much damage does it do, if any?
CQC!
It doesn't do...
Okay.
CQC to do it? Okay.
Yeah, that's my weapon.
Yeah, CQC is a standard action.
Okay.
How much damage is
standard
that?
Attack?
It does 5 damage, range 1.
Since
all right.
You're trying to judo throw her, it does 5 damage, and it will only take the movement action to get out then.
Okay.
I just like to imagine Big Kong getting fucked
five,
over the head and just picks
six.
Her up.
All right, now to the DPS.
You don't get to move, because you moved before
yeah,
you did your...
Yeah, you did.
Aw, shit. Yeah. Question, what are the walls of this pit made out of?
A stone.
Epithet.
Alright, Emmerich's turn.
Does it have a magnetic signature?
Now to
no.
The DPS duel happening
Damn
on the other side of the field.
Yeah, back to the DPS duel. yeah, after like, you know, taking the dropkick. Now allow me to show you my own personal technique. As he's going to use his standard attack, Demon Armor Claw Attack!
And then he gets a 20.
I don't need to give a plus 7 to that.
15.
Do 5 damage.
Yeah, Emmerich opens both of his claws, like, grabs Jamie's leg with one of them, like, pincering down on it, and then slams her over the head with the other one, knocking her to the ground.
Ah. Holy crap! Oh, that monster man just flipped her!
Emmerich,
you're not a bad fighter
a
yourself.
Do I want to take a movement? With that, Emmerich is gonna just take a step back, you know, alright, get up, come face me again, I want to see your strength!
Alright.
In the background, Otto is like, man, these guys never do things fairly. And it's your turn.
Go help out Ryla.
Which one of us? You never defined
one. And or and Ryla.
Yep.
We're both the same person. I think?
Ryla,
what are you going to do?
Alright, let's restrain Kong with these low dad claws.
Low dad claws!
Low dad!
What? Dad's the
You miss.
Too much.
Yeah.
Nothing happens. You whiff.
Yep. Okay.
I like to imagine, like, Mr. Right. Dad, like, pulls out his coupon for Red Lobster.
Yes. I have no idea what Red Lobster.
All right. Well, I don't.
But now
I don't
you
think
have a
this
discount.
Is, I don't think this is quite enough distance to dropkick. Plus, it did already do that. So instead, I'll just step up and. Go ahead and springboard.
Why do I have a feeling this is going to be our combat?
God damn it! I swear I didn't bring Alto! Why am I wrong?
No, you didn't bring Alto,
damage.
But I brought Emmerich!
Passive minus 5 on you?
No, yeah, Emmerich's passive doesn't do a minus 5 to anyone else.
Yeah, I know. I'm just...
Hear me or no? Yeah.
You're very quiet.
You do one damage to Emmerich, and you can go whatever direction.
Yeah.
All right. Just...
Oh, nice technique.
As you barely tapped me.
I mean, it was good technique. You didn't damage me, but it was good technique.
Hello.
Man, you just move. I'm not used to how you move. I'm used to more human opponents. No, no offense.
I mean, I am a vampire. I mean, I don't really take offense.
Wait, yeah,
cut to Charlie. Wait, he's also a vampire?
A vampire with a lobster claw.
Okay, I assume that helped.
Wait, like, everyone's just like, wait, you're a vampire? And nobody believes he's a vampire!
Wait, he's a vampire?
Yeah, sure, buddy! Vampire? Where? Damn it, I can't see how it's fit!
I just see a lobster. And an old guy.
I used to want to be a vampire too, buddy.
What are y'all doing?
Mustache might be a vampire.
Yeah, barely,
but
yeah,
we can.
Wow.
Damn it.
Well,
this movement is taken up to get out.
I'm gonna have to get out of this pit somehow.
In the action, like it's supposed to be.
Big Kong, are you wearing anything metal on you?
I would assume.
Technically not.
Now he is. Ryleth throws. I'm going to say Ryleth throws the steel ball.
Oh!
Okay.
Throwing the steel ball.
At Big Kong.
Oh no, 13!
Okay, so you get it,
sorry.
But also.
Wait.
Bad luck time!
First, I want to use my anytime westward bound.
Oh, yeah, right, yeah, other Ryleth saying anytime thing.
Yeah, I want to use. My anytime westward bound.
Big Kong, do you have any metallic? Is there something metallic that I can use to magnet myself out of this hole? No, completely ignoring the vending machine right above the hole.
No, I wasn't gonna magnet myself out of the hole. I was gonna pull him.
Oh. Pull him in.
Actually, I was gonna try to throw him off the map.
So okay, oh, so
oh.
Before we do anything, the auto. So Ryla throws the steel ball, and then Otto just, like, snaps, and it goes in the complete opposite direction.
That's weird.
And now, the chip coin toss is going to happen.
Alright!
Oh, by the way, Mr. Chip, I call
luck.
Because I have a head, but I don't have a tail.
Wow.
Cut to Jamie and Emmerich staring each other down, the good, the bad, and the ugly starts playing, and the steel ball rolls through like a tumbling.
This is weird.
Okay, so that is a failed call. So let me see what the second punishment is. A random enemy heals for 3 stamina.
No,
please.
Oh, it is random.
R1D3.
Please.
Okay, so 1 is Otto, 2 is Big Kong, 3 is Jamie.
Please, a 2.
2. 2. 2. That's fair.
Yeah, Jamie's
fair. Jamie gets 3 stamina.
Yeah, honestly, me and Jamie were the
ones that
it.
Okay, so...
I'm glad with that result, too.
So, that trying to throw the marble was your full action, so it is there anything
I have to get out of here somehow, so I am gonna try to get out of here.
Yeah, so it's movement action, right?
Pull myself out like this, using my movement action, and, well, oh, this is gonna take a lot. Well, I can't believe I'm trying this. Using my electric staff to create an electromagnetic signature to throw the vending machine at Big Kong.
Give me a roll for it.
Here. This is kind of stupid, so I'm gonna have. So I'm gonna use this. It's gonna take up some of my stamina too. 13!
Holy shit! I would like to use my anytime action to confuse him.
Confuse Ryleth.
Okay,
so.
Using unknown
well,
color.
Wait, that's a technicality here, and this is a her.
Yeah, okay.
One of my abilities makes technicalities more pronounced, meaning. One of my abilities makes technicalities way more pronounced. It's her passive.
Well, yeah, but Big Kong can still try. There's always the point.
Using the mystical, psychic, and epithet-based technique known as Codec Call, Big Kong can attempt to telepathically send a message to an enemy to attempt
wait,
to inflict
wait,
them
wait.
With confusion.
Telepathy, that's a mental effect. That means I'll take wild magic instead due to one of her abilities, yes.
Oh no.
Okay.
My mind is an enigma. Any and all psychological don't... Don't affect her. Is dead causing wild magic?
Okay, so Big Kong, do you still want to try and use your codec call in that case?
Fuck it, why not? Let's hit Ryla with wild magic.
Well, you gotta roll. Does he still have to roll with it, or?
And okay, so first off, Big Kong is going to roll for his codec call, which will then become a wild magic effect. Yeah. So roll for codec
if it
call.
Works.
Okay, so yes, that is it. And then roll a d300 at Ryla. And does anybody have the wild magic list open?
I do not.
I can get it open.
How do I roll d300 again?
Just roll slash roll one. Like,
I already rolled one.
There we go.
Okay.
292.
That's pretty high.
We can give me the effect.
I'll get the table. One second.
And then while that is going on, technically Ryla rolled the 13 on that. So she has to roll. She has to do the tail call.
Bad luck call.
I'm calling tails.
Tails? Alright.
Oh no.
Oh, she got
it. Oh no.
Tails is right.
Okay, so so you call it, nothing happens.
However, Ryla now gains a huge stack of ice cream scoops on a cone and is terrified that they will fall over. Keeping the stack from falling is now her number one priority.
Ryla has the stack of cones, and so she completely abandons her plan of the electromagnet because that would very easily cause the cones to fall over. Sylvia's Ryla still has a movement action, but trying to throw the marble was the main action, so... Sylvia.
I assume
You can
take...
pull something out if you want.
Oh, right, I can. Which one do you want, other than something to help the ice cream? The ice cream is sucky at best.
Plus, this has to be seemingly irrelevant, so... What's something that wouldn't make sense here?
How about we get a shot of LSD?
Yes.
What the
fuck? Yes.
I disapprove.
Yes.
Are you kidding? Like,
all kids in the audience, look away! Drugs are bad!
Jamie is too focused on Emery. Jamie's too focused on staring Emmerich down to notice the LSD.
Do I roll for LSD?
Yes, you roll for LSD.
Of course you get this one.
Oh.
You
roll for
LSD. Now.
Okay then!
I didn't know I had this.
You still have your movement action if you want to do anything.
I go over here and start berating Otto for no apparent reason.
Charlie, do we have to call the police or something? What's going on?
Let's just see how it plays out. If anyone actually gets high, then we can call the police.
They just pulled out drugs and...
DBA episode 14. The Combat 13 crew runs from the police.
Police chase.
Quick, everyone on the just cycle.
This episode is gonna be 10 drugs are bad.
Yeah, drugs are bad, kids. Bad luck and bad. Bad luck and bad.
She's crazy
drugs.
Enough. I don't want to see what she's like when she's like on something.
Oh, that can only end well.
I'm gonna hit Ryla question mark with change of floor plan.
Ooh, okay. Give us a roll.
Nice!
Oh, plus the ability. Plus the ability first.
The question is, does this upset the Tower of Ice Cream?
Oh, well, I'm the one holding the ice cream.
Yeah, not that. It's regular Ryla's holding it.
This was on the Ryla question mark, so that would not do that, I'm afraid. Because it was on this one.
Yeah,
alright. So, 7 damage, or launch them upward?
7 damage.
So, which one? So, Ryla question mark, you take 7 damage.
So, I guess just a piece of the floor flies up and just whacks you.
Yeah, just...
A metal rod just extends from the floor and then goes back.
Kong.
Kill you.
Alright, I'm gonna
attempt... Why is intestines on fire?
I'm going to attempt a CQC to throw Dad into the pit.
I see, I mean, it's gonna see that Big Kong's tactics haven't changed since
in all my years.
CQC!
If it ain't
no!
Broke,
no!
Little did you know, I'm a heavyset character.
A hug.
You just grab Mr. Dad and it's like, oh, and he hugs you back.
Yeah. Alright, I'm out of here. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Don't
run
from the hug.
I don't know how to handle affection!
Mark.
Alright,
back to the standoff, another tumbleweed goes past the plays as Emmerich stares Jamie back down and everything gets like really intense comic book thick outline all of a sudden. And Emmerich looks down at Jamie. You know, you have quite the amount of spunk, kid. I really like it. You're an excellent fighter for your age, especially. And as much as I am enjoying this duel, might I propose a temporary truce so we may assist both of our teams and then we can resume our combat?
Yeah, that's probably a good idea. I think I saw the monkey eating crap over there.
You distracted him! You're actually doing much more for the team than you would if you accepted his proposal. Please!
Well, Emmerich looks to Jamie. I mean, if you accept the monkey's proposal, I suppose I will have no choice but to accept your attack. However, I personally wish to assist my team, so we must continue our duel while also moving forward!
Me and Otto can handle...
Taking drugs.
Me and Otto can handle these three jokers. Please keep distracting him. I know I about him. He's too lucky.
I have to say, this is the most fun I've had fighting in a while, so I don't want to end the fight, but I don't want to stop you from helping your team. How about
yes,
we continue the duel? How about we keep going with the duel while moving over there?
A running duel. It could be like a racing battle. I like it. I like your style and your thought process. Let us continue. And on that note, Emmerich's going to, before he starts moving, if that's the case, now, again, I am very much so liking that idea. However, if we are continuing our duel, I suppose I could test you with this one. So he's going to use the Rock Lobster to drop it on Jamie.
I've been waiting for this one.
Yes!
Oh,
wow!
Oh, yes!
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 Why? No.
I should have left you to dead in your kingdom.
So, wait, there we go. Emmerich, the dark
give me a
aura.
While I grab it from the other thing.
The
do
dark...
I get a chance to run Judge out of the way, even though it's 20?
I don't know.
20.
The dark aura begins enveloping Emmerich again as he raises his claws to the sky. The dark energy manifests sky high above him, taking the form of a shadow. No wait, a rock. No wait, a rock lobster. Jamie.
Okay, Jamie, give me a dodge roll. It's going to be hard as hell to not just get crushed by.
See if you can take this one.
If there's any time to roll a 20. No.
Oh, it's close.
Alright,
Jamie, take this one.
What's his feelings?
I'm still looking for the lobster outside. Like, give me a
are you brave enough to take this one?!
Rage quits. Wasn't brave enough to take it.
Jamie looks at the screen. I have no other option. Rage quits. Opponent has disconnected. Back to server lobby.
Like, I imagine, like...
And he has a magnet, too!
And he has a magnet. Jamie just like is like looking at you, raising your arms in the air, just like anime head to like, what? Huh? Looks up.
Okay, so let me double check the effect of this. So
well,
and like, as soon as she looks up and sees this giant rock lobster dropping towards her, she actually looks like really panicked and like scared. A lot more scared than she normally would be.
I love him.
No,
so
using
much.
The magnet lobster.
Okay, so
using the magnet lobster.
Okay, so Jamie, it just.
I'm the ultimate fighter, or I will get hit by a giant lobster with a magnet.
You get
drop
over
shadow
here,
and live.
And it falls on your foot, and it deals 10 damage.
Ooh,
and it's
rough.
Going to. You're going to have to take an action to try and pull your foot out underneath it.
Oh, Emmerich, like, as it lands on Jamie. Well, there's no way you'll be able to run if you're like that. 1, 2, 3. Can I try and pull her out?
You used your action this turn, I'm afraid. So
all right. Well, Emmerich is here. I'll help you as soon as I'm able. I honestly was not expecting it to do that much.
Wait, what does your passive do? Does it help anyone?
Let me read it. Any ally that stands adjacent to Emmerich gains plus 5
damage.
Doesn't Jamie temporarily be an ally?
That's up to for DM to decide. Emmerich would consider her a friend.
Sure. Why not, right?
Yeah, why not? Hey.
Roll for GM. Roll to convince GM.
All right, Emmerich, roll another 20.
Right now.
That's not a 20.
Not a 20.
I'm afraid it doesn't count.
Well, Emmerich's here for moral support.
Hey, Dad, you wanna...
Where'd you get that?
Looks like you're gonna have to give her the talk.
I can explain.
There's a perfectly reasonable explanation. You'll find out,
What kind of self-respecting dad would let their child have drugs?
Don't worry, we're not gonna be the ones taking it.
Don't worry. Don't worry.
What kind of self-respecting dad would let their
child worried about what they are going to do with that.
Well, I suppose if you're not using it on yourself or selling it, it's fine.
There will be no money involved in this.
Children did drug deal confirmed.
All right. Let's see if I can knock off Otto with the lobster claws.
Oh no.
Oh no. Don't be a 20.
That's high.
15. Nice. Okay. Emmerich rolled on his first attack roll.
Remember, because we've decided that for DBA, your anytime refreshes on your turn. You can use your anytime against this.
Yeah, I'm gonna try and just make him turn to the west.
not to the west. No.
Hey, Dad, that's not the direction.
Ooh.
So I'm afraid you don't completely negate the attack, but instead of pushing you off the field, he pushes you in this direction.
He pushes you onto Ryla, and Ryla falls back into the pit.
So I go here?
Yeah, and you take 3 damage. And that is Mr. Dad's turn.
Alright. So when Emmerich walked over to Jamie, he actually notices she's like terrified looking, wide eyed, and like really panicked.
Oh, I'm sorry, child. It was meant to be a combat maneuver. I apologize if I've traumatized you. That was not the intent.
I'm gonna try and get out.
That guy just dropped an entire statue on that girl's foot. What the hell?
Successfully take your foot from under it. It's perfectly fine.
Oh.
She's just like, it's not your fault. It's just bad memories.
Understandable. We've all gone through trials and I cut out. We've all gone through trials and tribulations to get to where we are today. And as experienced as a fighter you are, I'm sure you've had plenty to overcome.
Yeah, I'm just gonna sit here for a minute. Jamie's just gonna end her turn there.
I'm just gonna kick you in the face.
No, we can get back to fighting next round.
Understandable.
And Ryla ?
Don't worry, Dad. We don't do drugs. What? Otto does drugs though. Ryla,
Otto, why?
That would cause wild magic. Fuck. I was gonna I would like to confuse her so that she takes the drugs, but shit. You can't do that!
Joke's on you, I'm perpetually on LSD.
Well, that one is.
You just admitted
it. I don't.
Dude,
this
do
is
I
illegal.
Roll to make
I'm sorry, she's saying.
And auto take.
What? I would like to use Big Kong's talent, making those snakes solid, to convince Ryla to not drug on.
Convince is a mental effect. It's a mental state.
I guess technically it is.
It is technically, and my passive increases technicalities.
Just cause confusion, and then wild magic will happen. And maybe
think about it.
There's more wild magic here.
Big Kong, if you're doing wild magic, there's a chance that the LSD might get affected.
Yeah.
Fuck, you know what, why not? Also, my fucking talent doesn't cost any stamina anyway.
Yeah, so...
Oh, boy.
Well, roleplay it out, Big Kong.
No.
Hey, there we go.
So, give us the D300 on Ryla question.
Yeah, I like to imagine, like, Big Kong takes out the cigarette, puffs out a smoke, and then does an incredibly sexy monkey pose towards Ryla.
251 or my roll?
251.
251, let me get it.
What we did for the other one.
251, target now needs glasses. If the target has glasses, they now need 3D glasses.
Right.
Wait, wait. I know this is kind of screwing over my own team, but if she needs glasses, is she imprecise with the stab?
Yeah. It depends. Nearsighted or farsighted?
Give me a second.
Nearsighted or farsighted?
Give me a second.
Yeah, give
him
a second.
Oh.
Okay, so. You're trying to force Otto to take drugs, so give me a. High as you try and force Otto, low as you try and force Ryla.
Well, drugs would be a mental effect anyways.
Ooh. Oh, and it's going to be a mental effect.
Oh, boy.
So that means Ryla, the other Ryla takes another D300. And
just shoving
Dad,
it the other Ryla's mouth.
And
just eat this.
Mr. Ryla, and Mr. Dad sees Ryla take drugs.
Ryla.
Fuck you!
You lied.
Technically, she lied!
Mr. Dad's rage mode.
I lied.
If you want, you can make that a 16.
Oh yeah,
just
sure.
Get
you can take Mr. Dad's 16.
Increase it, please.
Yes, please do. I want to stab Otto, not my sister.
All right.
Injecting me with drugs. This is illegal.
All right, they're totally just injecting a kid with drugs. Let's call the police.
Otto, going to resist the effects of drugs or something? I don't know.
Okay, would my passive come into effect here?
What is your passive?
The sight of some weird monkey robot thing trying to seduce Ryla has made her blind. Which inadvertently makes her drug her sister.
Okay,
well,
so...
Well, I guess now I have to roll 1d300. How do I do that again?
What's going
well,
on?
Well, didn't,
okay.
Well, didn't
you
take Mr. Dad 16?
Yeah.
Mr. Dad gave
oh, yeah.
a 16 to Ryla, so yeah. Ryla is giving Otto the drugs.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
So, were you trying to stab it, or were you trying to force it? Okay, so what exactly
force it
were
into
you
him.
Doing?
Make him
force
high.
Force it into him. Make him high, yes.
Give me a roll to resist the effects of the drugs.
Oh.
Oh, no.
He's a first-timer.
Super high, I'm afraid. Damage from the injection or whatever.
Hashtag team bad luck.
Well, I'm gonna quickly get rid of this ice cream, by the way.
Well, no,
I'm,
you're talking
I'm going
right,
to
no.
create a bl- okay. I'm going no. to- I'm going to pull out a blowtorch. That's right, a blowtorch.
It's keeping it from falling is your main concern, you can't do that.
Yeah,
but
you don't
it's
want
not
to-
falling, it's melting. Falling
yes,
is melting.
The,
yeah, but then
the
liquid is falling.
That it would fall.
Well, then I'm gonna- well, then I'm gonna light Otto on fire, then.
Logical next step.
This is really,
pull out,
really
okay. Awesome. So, give me a second. Okay, so you pull out the blowtorch because you're using one hand. Give me a d20 check to make sure you're keeping the ice cream cones in
okay.
balance.
14.
Good.
So, question: is this just like the scene from the Clockwork Orange where it just injected with drugs?
Okay, so I did a GM roll for ice cream falling over, and it was higher than yours, so I'm afraid the ice cream starts to tip over, so you drop the blowtorch and focus back on the ice cream, so nothing happens.
Aww. Oh, damn it!
What else can I do? So I've already injected a kid with drugs.
There's still a blowtorch on the floor!
There is a blowtorch on the floor, but I assume that was my main action.
Yeah, I would assume that's like a main action.
Your main action, yes.
You still have your movement.
Action.
You have your movement.
I think that I have to take out a surprise kill that's going to help me defend it, but I'm not sure which one.
Can you take out the antidote?
I would
well, that'd be too relevant. It can't be relevant to what's happening.
What if I take out...
Wow, she's just sitting there, digging through her coat.
Sylvia, what did you take out? You literally faded into nothingness in terms of sound.
Okay, so question. Can I roll to succeed and then roll a 1d150 for getting a Desmond King trophy?
No.
Okay. Desmond King has some pretty interesting trophies.
What about a can of fizz? Can I do that?
Okay, you can roll to see if you can get a can of fizz, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, let's just have more wild magic, you know. It's...
Yeah, sure, why not?
Yeah. This combat isn't, like,
necessarily enough drugs.
Oh, no. I wanted to take out a sticky bar instead, but...
Don't forget you guys have those sevens from Emmerich.
Well, no, wasn't it said that only Emmerich can use them?
The plus sevens are only on Emmerich.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. Well,
Do I get a
Fizz Classic. You get Fizz Classic.
Is it a free action to force Otto to drink the Fizz Classic?
No, it is not a free action to force someone to drink. You can...
Why are you trying to force
Otto to
drink it yourself, but forcing it on another player is a main action.
Myself, Ryla. It's pretty disgusting.
Preferably not! I'd probably be tasting it too!
Oh, no.
Are we letting an actual criminal fight kids? What's happening here?
Cultist, not criminal!
In that case, he just has a can of fizz. That's it.
Otto's turn. You are currently on drugs.
Well, I'm on drugs, so my hand's gonna change.
You're gonna wanna run!
I'm just gonna... How does drugs affect my movement?
I'll say your movement is fine, except you'll have to roll to not believe there's a hallucination in front of you.
Okay.
What is this strange monkey in front of me? Wait.
Oh no.
Oh,
so you believe that there is a third Ryla right beside Mr. Dad.
So basically, you wouldn't be able to stand in this space, but you could, like, move around it?
Can I convince Otto she's not there?
You don't know what he doesn't see.
Yeah, that's true. You don't
know.
Yeah,
well, he can still walk around her.
Yeah, it'll just...
Around.
Well, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... One, two,
just three. Run!
Okay. Just run!
Five.
He's like, ah!
Give me a check to make sure that there isn't any drug hallucinations by Big Kong.
Also, can I say that he might fall into the pit?
Well, no, we said that the actual...
He's already dead!
It's affecting his movement, it's just... He sees.
You've already drugged the man! Just leave him alone!
So you imagine that there's a giant pit right next to Big Kong, so that will affect your movement, I'm afraid.
Yeah, so like right, okay. Right, like to his left, like here, or?
To his left, yes.
Okay,
because this was the last space he was at for his first movement, and then he double moved, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. He was one space ahead before he double moved.
Yeah. Oh, well.
Can I move through allies?
Yes.
Yeah, you can move through allies.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well.
Oh my god, what is even happening?
Horseshit is what's happening. Yeah, Otto, you need to leave and you need to heal.
So, Big Kong.
Okay. This is going to seem really dumb until the end of my turn, in which case you're all going to be like, oh man, that was really smart. What?
Rugs.
3, 4, 5. I would like to use my passive utility belt of legends, which, if I read, if Big Kong manages to get a hands on any weapon of any kind, he can place on his utility belt, keeping it permanently, unless someone steals it back and I'm taking up Blowtorch.
Ooh!
Oh, that is a free action. So
grabbing
something is a free action, so you get it.
And then I'm going to use my box out of sight by pulling out a not suspicious in the slightest box. Big Kong somehow manages to disappear completely from enemy sights, confusing them greatly.
Well, in this thing, Naked Ape has his movement speed cut in half as he is attempting to move stealthily.
It's also something. Full
for box.
It doesn't confuse you directly. It doesn't confuse you directly, but I still disappear from your sight.
Yeah, it's not like a mental effect.
It's not a mental effect. It's
a Pop Tart box. You're just wearing it as a hat.
It's not a box. Don't get in the box. Yeah. You just pull it out.
Also, just to point out, really quickly, because I am the one that helped Dream come up with that passive for Big Kong. When I said permanently, I mean like if this combat ends and he still has it, he has it.
Oh.
Oh boy.
Kind of like a Vargas situation where he can keep the powers.
Right. Okay,
so you grab the blowtorch and then you take out a box. You just have a box now.
Can I have a free action to set the box on fire to scare them?
Scare is a mental
scare
effect.
Scare would be a mental effect.
Fucking what?
Are you sure you do that?
Convince the GM that setting fire is a free action.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
There you go.
He might be sure.
Wait, the box is on your head, so so wouldn't
well,
be
no,
on
he,
fire too?
He's just
no,
holding
no.
It.
He just pulled it out it because he rolled a 3, so it's not on his head.
Sorry,
this
I looked away for a second.
This is on fire. And... Okay, so there's a box now on fire. Mr. Dad, roll a will save to not be like, oh my god, a fire.
Roll a will save.
My dad roll to suppress dad instincts.
Yeah. I must save my monkey kid from the fire.
Yes, save me from the fire! Throw me towards Otto!
So your reason that it's a cardboard box, so it should be fine since this is a metal floor. And both Rylas give me saves to not be under the effect of a mental effect, which would then give you wild magic.
Please be a 1. That's not a 1.
Okay. Well,
I okay.
Wow. That
okay. So everyone
on fire
is on
your head, Mr. Monkey.
No, it's not on his head. We already said.
Well,
this.
That happened. Not the most insane thing I've seen all week, but that happened.
So there's just currently a box on fire.
Honestly, you're the most insane thing I've seen all week.
Pyromaniac big guy.
Meanwhile, on the other side of the universe.
Screw the system. Fuck the man.
Meanwhile, in
the
plot.
Yeah. Meanwhile, in plot B.
Meanwhile, back at the TPS fight.
Emmerich looks to Jamie consolingly. So, Jamie, are you ready to fight again? Are you feeling better?
Yeah, I'm good now.
So, you... Cool. So, Emmerich gets into, like, a fighting stance. So you're okay with whatever I do, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Don't roll another 20.
Before I do my next move, I'd like to point out, because of all the temp HP Emmerich has had, despite all the abilities he's used and damage he's taken, he is at full stamina.
God damn it.
So,
this match is actually fucking horseshit.
What Emmerich is going
to Otto and Jamie are already almost
what dead. Emmerich is going to do is use March of the Mollusks, which I'll read it out before I do this just so for effect. I used it in the previous one, but yeah, vampire is basically he can turn into a swarm of Lobats while summoning a bunch of them. He has another this allows him to have another move action, implying that afterwards he would be able to move still. And basically he can charge and like drag things with him, charge into things in that kind of a manner. So let me roll it. That's pretty good.
Of course it's a good roll. Emmerich.
So yeah, Emmerich turns into a swarm of Lobats, grabs Jamie, and goes 1.5, 3, 4.5. That's for his movement dragging Jamie. Presumably, I'd like to do damage dragging her across the ground, but how much would that do?
Okay. I would say because you're like pinching her and stuff, you deal like 3 damage as you drag her.
Okay. And then he's going to use his actual movement for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and at the description there it says transforming back to his normal form acts as a bonus action, so he's going to take that and transform back to normal.
Okay.
Alright, Jamie, come at me!
Hey, Dad, did you know that Otto is taking drugs right now?
I was put under the pressure.
You should go and not kill him, but...
You saw them drug him!
But he's still on drugs, please! You need to help him!
You watched with your own eyes, 2 feet away, them stick the needle in him.
I'm sorry. These glasses aren't really functional. They have a bunch of names and birthday dates written on the inside of the lenses.
That's a good piece of lore.
Give me a roll for BSing a way to not attack your own allies or whatever.
Yeah, I think that's appropriate. Yeah, there we go.
Oh, a 19, you say?
Ooh.
Oh! Oh!
Well, damn.
That's
snap. Yeah.
Mr. Dad thing.
Okay, sweet.
Put on Mr. Sword Dad thing. Oh
my god. I feel like it
boy,
should.
Oh, it's a sword 19. Okay, it's
so
a sword.
At what point of the battle do we. At what point of the battle do we say, since we already know the outcome of this, do we stop?
It's technically way for the balance to be restored. Okay, so. That's a stored 19, but I'll allow you to, because it's a 20 on using it, you can store another roll without having to waste the 19.
Okay. Right, that's a bonus action. That's a free, that's a once per round thing, though, so I can't use it again to immediately take the 20.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you still have, yeah, you still have your regular, you have another action. As
regular
well.
Turn. And movement.
Yep.
Otto, he's taking drugs and it's not good.
Yeah, he needs some help.
What? The DJ's taking drugs, what?
Otto looks like, wait.
What are you doing?
Do not focus on me, maybe taking drugs.
Hey there.
Dad tries to snap to get Otto's attention, but realizes he has low dad claws now.
He just clicks.
Otto.
Oh.
Otto, you're going to be fine trying to console him with these freaky claws.
Roll for dadliness.
Loves the dad.
A 7!
Stuff.
Okay.
Before we do resolve the drugs, heads or tails?
Let's go heads.
I've got a good feeling about this one.
Hey.
Hey, what, that was number 5.
Hey. Luck pays off.
Oh, okay. You have a saved crit fail.
Nice.
Nice, okay.
Wait.
Do I have to
what?
Use it?
You can only do it on allies, damn it.
Good.
Okay. So, what the fuck was that?
I put a 1 in the max thing because I've been keeping track of the 19 in the other bar.
I was just confused. Okay. So, because that was 7 is the luck number today, I'll say that you can manage to get Otto out of his drug trip.
Yeah.
Hey, thanks. You know, you're... Wait, I'm not drugged anymore. I get to have my British accent back.
Wanted him to stay drugged for a while longer.
Yes.
Oh, good.
Thank you very much. And I'm sorry about this, but I'm going to use my anytime to push him into the hole.
Thank you for snapping out of my drug trip! 13! Yeah.
I too have watched The Lion King.
Wait a minute. You're not me.
Long live the dad.
Before we have Dad go into the pit, the chip coin toss.
Oh yeah!
Wait, what? Oh, does that count? Oh, it does, yeah.
13.
Alright, heads or tails?
Heads.
Let's go!
Hey!
Hey.
Okay, so you called it wrong, so let me see.
He called it heads. It's right.
Heads. There it is.
Oh, I thought he called it tails for some reason.
Oh.
Okay, so Mr. Dad gets shoved into the pit. That's a regular pit, so on his next movement action, we'll have to be taken to get out of the
pit. Whoa, what a betrayal! That kid's...
Jamie.
That's kind of a dick move.
All right, memories don't matter right now. What matters... Battle strands, come on. She just slaps both her cheeks with her hands really quick. All right, back to the fight. Dropkick Emmerich.
Hey, you got
it! There we go.
He says, get it kicked in the face.
Great job!
Great job, Jamie! Ah!
Okay, so Emmerich takes 8 damage.
Yeah, 8 damage, that's fair. Emmerich,
you can shave it off.
And does he get knocked? He gets knocked. They both get knocked to the floor, okay.
Yeah.
Alright, so yeah, Emmerich's like. That was your best hit yet! Ow! My face!
There we go. There we go, just needed to get into the mood.
Wow!
That could have gone a bit better.
Yeah, it could have.
Hey DM, can I use my one ability to pull out the Pokemon Gulpin?
What?
That's not an item, that is a creature!
Pokeball yeah, that's with a, that, yeah, that's Pokeball with Pokemon creature. In it.
Roll like for a Pokeball, but then that would be a different thing to see what Pokemon is inside.
Yeah.
I need
yeah.
to
get
the return. If any Pokemon's inside at all.
Hey, you do have a Pokeball.
But in before it's either Garbagemon or the dead Umbreon.
You should use the stored one to
it's just wordless.
Which Pokemon?
Yeah, do it.
One second, I'm going to look up the national index and how many Pokemon in total there
that's
are.
That's what I was that's what I was thinking for deciding which one.
Oh yes, we summoned Dialga!
Can I roll?
Yes, it's a fortress. That explosion.
Yes, fortress. Everyone blows up again.
For the third time in DBA, everyone blows up.
So
third time.
Can people hear me?
Okay,
yes.
Yeah,
okay. A D-806 to see which Pokemon you summon.
That's crazy.
I'll look it up myself because, oh boy.
192,
that's pretty low.
Did you?
806, actually. So one, you're gonna have to re-roll that since that
that's
was-
That's Sunflora! No! Keep it!
The wrong number.
It's the wrong number,
have to re-roll.
Yeah, she has to re-roll.
D-806.
You rolled an 806.
That,
wow.
That is not how
wow,
that works.
That is not how that works.
Yeah.
No. I'll roll it for you if you want, Sylvia!
That's not a Pokemon.
I can
that's
roll it
gear.
For you, do you want me to?
You're right there, Sylvia.
You summon a creature for
there
806. You go. There you go, 440.
That sounds like a Sinnoh Pokemon.
It's Happiny!
Yeah, it probably is.
Oh, it's Happiny.
Okay, good, they got a useless piece of shit.
I mean, Happiny can...
Dream, have you seen the anime?
Happiny's fucking low.
Happiny's whopping low.
That is a picture and uploaded as a token.
You should have specified that it was from
I'll
the anime then.
So I'm assuming that Ryla bringing out the Pokeball and then using it, is that like an action?
I think using the Pokeball is an action.
Oh, right. It didn't work how I intended it to in the slightest.
Deciding on if it's an action or not will be... Roll to convince GM it's your Pokemon and not just a Pokeball you stole.
You sure stole someone's beanie.
It's Team Rocket.
We have Jesse, and
make it double.
That's right.
because this is not loyal to you, it will be a free action.
Jesse, and Big Kong.
That's right.
I never agreed to this. Wait, if the Happiny doesn't belong to her, can I use my talent to convince it to be free?
Oh, you can convince it to 5 feet.
Or rather, convince it to join us.
Yeah.
Convincing Happiny.
Convince
you can do that as a reaction on your
turn.
Get the Big Kong theme.
Get the theme.
Yeah, but I'm on it.
I got it.
Oh, sorry. I'll just let you do it then. Sorry.
Rayla actually stole Big Kong's beanie. So Big Kong can
take his
beanie.
Oh, it's beanie. You bastard.
Master.
Do you want to kill the Happiny?
Yeah. But how the fuck am I gonna get rid of all this goddamn?
Why are you people like this? Why are you a monkey?
Emmerich looks over. Rayla, no need to be racist.
Serious.
Yes, you can't control
Dream or Dream. What's your roll 20 thing so that I can give you control over it? Monkey
Man? It's Monkey Man.
It's Monkey Man.
Can I roll to pick up the Happiny and throw it at Big Kong?
that, I'm afraid.
Well...
Sylvia, can you say that again? I don't...
Can I, roll to pick up Papini and throw it at Big Kong?
You can
Don't worry about that. Yeah.
You can roll for it.
Right. Can Papini right. roll the struggle out?
Rylan, do you want me to roll?
Well, do what you want. I'm at this point now just wondering where the hell.
Oh!
Of course.
Wow. Yes!
Boy, okay.
Rylan theme, I guess. Ah, yes, Cultist Guild Crit.
Yeah, because her name was decided.
A bit of egg on your face.
So, Ryla takes up Big Kong's Hapini and throws it right at him.
Hold on. They both take
3 damage.
3 for 20.
Looking too good.
Hold on. I gotta pull up Hapini's Pokedex entry to see if I can bullshit my way out of this.
A round egg shaped and locked in its belly pouch and gives the
shit,
rock.
Shit, it weighs 53 pounds! Fuck!
Dude, you weigh less! That's like as much as you!
Okay, well then. In that case, Hapini takes 3 damage, Big Kong takes 5.
Fuck you!
Oh.
Ryla sticks her tongue out at Big Kong.
Okay.
Can I just take the 3?
Did not because you decided to bring the facts into it, and the Ryla's passive makes it that it has to count that way.
Technicalities are more pronounced!
True.
Well, now I have to find some way to get rid of this fucking ice cream still. Hey, what happens if you feed it to a monkey?
Who'd roll to eat the ice cream yourself?
Roll
to
force feed the monkey!
Okay.
You want to give him ice cream?
Things right. to people.
Force feed.
Roll for force feeding. Oh boy. Okay.
It heals me.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, actually. So.
Well, like, all the ice cream's gone, so that's all that matters.
No, just feeding him ice cream.
Okay, so Big Kong, roll for liking ice cream for however much stamina you're gonna get back.
Oh boy. Don't say he's getting back 19.
My favorite is Rocky, bro.
No. That's
my
a 4,
favorite
right?
flavor is dirt.
Stamina,
like,
because
ice cream
that is your favorite
now.
Ice cream.
What?
You get 6 stamina.
Hey!
His favorite flavor.
And then Ryla.
I don't care. I want the fucking ice cream gone.
I could have eaten it. I like ice cream.
It's her tails.
I don't care.
It's her tails.
Me?
Oh.
Oh, me?
No, Althanis, because yeah. Ryla rolled 7.
Well, Tails.
Hey!
Tails.
Number 6 is... you have a saved nat 20.
Of course.
Well...
wait, was this the 7th time? Is this the 7th time? Is that why?
6.
No, that was number 6.
Oh, okay.
The next one will be 7.
Well, that took up an action, so I really can't use it. But I do not want to be standing here still, so I'm gonna move to here. And
you
I guess
can't move all the way. Now you can move through Ryla.
You can't move. Okay, so if you're doing that, you're gonna have to move through Ryla, so that would have taken 3 spaces.
1, 2, 3. I have 4 movement.
Yeah, she has 4.
Okay, I was just making sure that you knew how much you. Is that all you're gonna do?
Yeah, I've already used an action. I think forcing.
I was just making sure that you were gonna- that's where you wanted to stop.
I just wanted to be out of the corner.
I'll do here, because then we can match.
Yes.
Okay. By the way, before Otto is- I cut it out. Can I just say that Ryla's theme is amazing?
Yeah, it's pretty great.
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah.
Myself.
You can't. Healing abilities can't be used on them on the user.
Yes, they can.
Stupid.
Technically, I'm my own ally.
Yeah.
Don't want to play it like that.
By all technicalities.
Otto.
Honestly, I mean honestly.
It's technicality.
Yeah.
Why this passive works against them in this count?
I don't have passive.
No. Ryla's passive is technicalities, and technically the thing says allies, so the healer can heal himself in this case.
Yes, that's a perfect explanation.
Yeah, that does work!
Otto takes 1 stamina for using the ability, and then gains 4 from having a heal, so he has a +3 in total on this.
Yeah, I'm no longer at half health.
Would you like to move?
Yes. One, two. This is a drug.
Ooh, watch out for that. Oh, wait, real. That doesn't exist anymore.
Since you're not on drugs anymore, I'll delete that.
Four, five.
Since you're not on drugs.
Kong.
Well,
still under a Pokemon.
Papini. I'm pitting Ryla.
This Ryla?
Give me a second.
Yes.
Okay.
Now pit the other
with
Ryla.
With Papini, or are you just attacking?
The pit.
Using the pit.
Pit the other Ryla.
The big, okay. The big whole bullshit ability that I dislike.
Okay. So you summon a pit underneath the Ryla, but their next move and action will be taken to get out.
Okay.
You want to move, I'm guessing?
Yeah. I already took it. One.
You can also have, have a Hapini action.
Man. Two. That is three.
By the way,
four.
Hapini's
five.
Ability is Serene Grace.
That's actually a really good ability for a DBA setting.
Yeah.
Hapini is going to use Copycat on Big Kong. Pit Ryla.
The other Ryla, you mean? Or
yes.
Ryla,
yes.
Yeah, give me Hapini's roll.
Hey.
The second Ryla's entire turn will be devoted to getting out of the pit.
Good. Oh great! Now we're both stuck again.
Ooh. All right. I'm assuming, but now that it's Emmerich's turn, since I was knocked down, do I have to use my movement to get up?
Yes.
Okay. So Emmerich stands back up. As I said before, that was a great hit, Jamie, and as much as I'd like to continue our duel, Emmerich looks to Ryla and Mr. Dad. It seems as if all my teammates are temporarily a little bit underground, and I'd like to ameliorate that situation. Dad! Ryla! Which one of you needs to get up more direly?
There
they do.
Ryla.
Oh! They're a bit under the weather.
Looks like they're
more like
down
under the ground.
All right, Jamie. Like obviously, this is a fight, so continue attacking me as if you so desire, because that is the point of a duel. However, he is going to use March of the Mollusk again to get another movement to move over there.
All right.
So let's roll for that. Hey.
Good.
So yeah. So
are you going to Ryla or Dad? I didn't.
I'm
hear.
Going to Ryla because Dad said Ryla needed it more. So, Emmerich is going to transform into the swarm of Lobats. Go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I'm guessing I can't do anything to pull them out like right now. Or.
Yeah.
Because you get an extra movement, I'll say you can go into the pit and try and like help them climb out.
Okay. Would I? Since I know that the Ryla directly in front of me is like. Fully fucked. Would I not be able to get that one? Should I go for the other one, or is it like?
Go for the other one.
I was saying you can do that. This one. That way, they only have to take a movement.
Oh, okay. Yeah, no, I'll definitely do that. So, should I roll for that? Ballast, should I roll for that, or is it just a thing?
Yes, you should roll for it. I guess I cut out.
There we go. Emmerich is being Emmerich.
Wow!
Come on, Ryla.
It will only take. It will only take that Ryla's movement action to get out.
Now is not the time to be. There's better places to take a nap than on the ground, you know.
I know.
Because you rolled high, it will be half movement for that one instead.
Hey.
Mr. Dad, and you're technically you're still in low bad form technically.
Yes, I know. I specifically because I was pulling her out. So.
Half. All right. How far can you go on that march of the smallest?
March of the Mollusk is just another movement action. Like, now that he's in the form, he just has standard movement, but...
Okay. Does it do damage? Does it do damage? Okay.
Wait. Do you get two movements for using Lobat, or is that just... Because otherwise it's just an ability that's double move.
Yeah, no, the thing is with March of the Mollusk is that it has the capability to, like, drag people with him. Which is what he did to Jamie. So you can, like, charge into people. That's like,
you have one action. What will you do?
Let's go. A couple really good ones.
You could use, can I recommend, using it's a surprise tool that'll help us later somehow?
Yeah, you could do that, or you could use March of the Mollusk to, like, grab Otto or Big Tom and do whatever.
Turning into Low Dad?
Yeah, Low Dad.
Low Dad.
That's. That's just too fun of an idea to pass up. Let's go low dads.
And remember, if this doesn't work, you can use your 19.
Oh yeah.
Okay, so you can either do, you can either use the 14 or you could use the 19 to
more than that one.
Let's go for the 14.
I'm imagining like their lobsters with
numeric effect is doubled. So what I'll say you can do is you can take the movement, but then you'll have an extra movement while in the low bat form, and then you'll have the regular movement that allows you to do still.
Ooh.
Dragging movement and then one regular movement.
Yeah.
Okay. Regular over it's here and let's
head of dad.
Fly with wait, them over. What?
Fly
okay,
with
so the
yes.
You already used your movement action, which would mean it's you only get the two dragging.
Well, the thing is that he'd need to get over to Big Kong to drag him first, so that's what I'm assuming. That
yeah,
but I mean, the dragging movement it would be the four dragging and then another four dragging because he can't get an extra four after that because he's already
yeah
used
no
his
no
movement,
because
is what I'm saying.
Yeah no because he's standing there. What I think he's saying is that he's using his first to go to Big Kong and his second to go back to the pit.
Yeah. Okay. So. Okay, so you're going 2.5 grab. 3.5. Okay. 1.5, 2.5. 4. And what's your movement speed?
It's 4.
4. And you are dragging him into this pit, right?
Yeah.
Yep. 5. And give me a roll to dump Big Kong in the pit.
Note that you have the 19.
But it's part of the ability that
I
you roll.
I do have a 19, you
oh. Oh, and because of Big the last Kong. 20, you can store the second 19 if you get it.
Yeah.
Okay, so Big Kong,
oh.
Your next movement is stolen. Ooh.
Hey, you lose
I'm
a 19.
Afraid. You lose the 19 that you had stored.
What?
I don't know about that. I feel like you just
shouldn't. It's a critical failure!
Yeah, no, but he got it from a critical 20.
Okay, I'll say, okay, so the 19 is now a 16 instead,
okay.
And you can't store an extra one.
Okay.
That's quite a bit. Okay.
I think this is also partially balancing because of
And Big Kong's movement is now taken up for his next turn.
This can I just say this song
because
is
because you were dragging, he takes 3 damage from the pinches and stuff.
This is the most climactic to continue Jamie and Emmerich's duel.
I'm loving this.
What?
I don't even know what's happening anymore.
Alright, sorry, I'm just
in
basking
awe.
In this.
Yeah, in awe. Understandable, have a nice day.
Alright, just gonna move 1, 2, 3, and as a pass by, you know, I'm first just gonna post the...
Emmerich is a bunch of low bats right now, so attacking would be weird.
Yeah, so I mean, it still deals damage. Honestly,
I'm still gonna try.
Okay.
You go for it.
Because I can still move afterwards.
Yeah. Nice.
5 damage.
It's 4 because I'm using my passive.
Oh, okay, 4
for this.
All right.
It's 4, and whenever Emmerich reforms as a regular person, like one of his, like. Part of his lobster mustache will be gone because the low bat that was that one got crushed.
Yeah.
Does that mean she kicks Emmerich while he's on the ladder, knocking him down into the
pit?
Well,
he's not on the ladder. He pulled Ryla out of the pit. And plus, he's a swarm of flying lobsters, so...
Surprise! Jamie's luck actually isn't normal bat.
So is it Ryla?
Yes.
All
right.
So Emmerich, I never said he couldn't speak in this form. So can he?
Yeah.
Okay. What? So Emmerich turns to the Rylas. Okay. Now that you're that you're out of the pit, both of you, I propose we work together for a tri-tech, I suppose.
Oh, okay.
Or dual tech, yes. Since you're technically just one person.
Yeah, I suppose it still is a dual tech. You know what I mean.
Yeah.
Yes, and exactly.
Just to make sure that you remember, this Rylus still has half movement, yes, because of the way Emmerich's help.
Mm-hmm. But because so long as they have their actions, the dual tech I have planned is fine. So they would get moved back to my turn, right?
If both Rylus want to be part of the dual tech, yes. If only one of them does, I will make a copy and
theoretically, it could be fine with just using one, but I'm cool.
I think that I'll offer up my Ryla to a dual tech, but
We could do both. That could make it even better if we do both.
Sure.
Both of you are out.
Emmerich, which one of us do you need? Do you need like both of us at the same time?
He rather both of you if y'all would both do it. Is what I was just checking.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay.
Okay.
I'll do it, but. I don't know.
Both want to do it, then y'all.
I'm fine with it.
Down. I mean, like, realistically, the dual tech I have planned only requires one of them, but if you both want to do it just for kicks, then go for it.
Oh, it only requires one of them?
Yeah. Like, it doesn't.
It would work better if he has support to make sure that. Well, if he only has one, there's a possibility one of you might screw up your role.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, I'll offer.
Here, how about you do it? I have a very stupid thing I want to attempt.
Yeah. So yeah, make a copy of Ryla, and then Ryla's behind with Emmerich, and then
Sylvia's Ryla is with Emmerich. Yes. I'll add Elthanas's back to the top of turn order.
Cool.
All right.
Ryla's turn now.
No, it's still Elthanas's Ryla because she has her action still. She used her movement to get out.
Well, using my nat 20, yes, I'm going. Use it. I'm going to pull out MatPat from earlier.
No!
Oh god.
Ah! Fucking doing it!
Okay, give me
still the nat 20 anyways.
Okay, so nat 20, let me put your crit theme on.
Oh my god.
This doesn't deserve a crit theme.
It really doesn't.
Actually, okay, give me a second.
Don't get the game theory
is.
Theme, I'm gonna scream.
Oh god.
Oh.
One.
Oh.
Okay.
It's the wrong one.
What are you trying to play?
Yes! Perfect.
I'm gonna scream! Okay.
It's me, MatPat, from Game Theory.
Wow!
Theories that they want.
Wow! This begs the question, theoretically, are Pokemon loyal to anyone?
No, it's Gecko's.
I mean, yes, there was an entire generation of Pokemon games.
I don't know, that was.
That they were.
Dream, would that affect MatPat and making a video about it.
Well, I mean, you're not wrong!
Game theory. Is this actually Ryla's opinion? And I'm going to roll for game theory.
The evidence says.
Is Happini mess?
Oh no.
So, game theory. This is actually a third party Happini that works for itself.
Oh, I see.
Pat is going to call heads.
I got a 20 to convince it!
And he got a.
Ryla used
a 20
to
summon
MatPat. So this is going to be MatPat's calling of head.
I hate this.
This is the worst.
This is the effect that MatPat unlocked. Charlie Betts enters combat on the target side.
No! There's a third team of MatPat, Happini, and Charlie Betts!
Oh my god.
Charlie,
what are you doing? Dante was right, this is the worst timeline.
Okay,
it truly is!
While I make the MatPat turn.
Burn it! Everything! Just burn it all!
Dante was right, this is the worst time.
Hey, can the two teams go on a temporary truce to deal with this?
I mean, you might need to convince
them. You know what?
Oh wait, yeah.
Yes!
Oh, yeah.
Yes, turn this into a PvE match, yes!
Yes!
Yes. Okay. Both teams win! They realize fucking up map pad is more important!
I really screwed up by summoning him, let's kill him!
Yeah.
If that's the case, let me come up with a random...
Your hand only makes me stronger.
Oh god.
Theory, you're all screwed.
Game theory, this is actually PvE.
You have to fight Charlie too, because he joined Matt Pat.
Yeah, and Happini!
We have to fight Charlie, Matt Pat, and Happini.
Okay, and I will actually come up with an ability for Matt Pat. Just a theory. Okay, so I'm going to type out what the ability is now. Just a theory. Matt Pat can roll to change reality to fit any stupid idea he comes up with.
Is this a new combat?
Anything else you'd like to do?
Wait, are we? Does that mean we're Team Purple now with Blue and Red combining for PvE?
Yes.
Yes.
This is now PvE.
Jamie, our duel will have to wait.
So, Ryla, you used the free action ability, yeah. So you still have a regular attack or whatever you want to do against Matt Pat.
Whoa! Worst!
This comment's getting boring, let's make it PvE.
Hell yeah! Charlie, what are you doing? Why are you fighting for that guy?
What the hell is going on? Because I have to fight with this guy now.
What? Who knows anymore?
Who don't even know?
Let's see, well if Matt Pat's that big... Wait a second, he's huge! Huh.
That's just a theory.
Biggest man on the internet.
That's just a theory.
Game theory! Is Wario 10 feet tall?
His icon's that big, and technically that means he's that big.
Is Wario 10 feet tall?
Second, I have to loop his combat theme.
I'm going to... Oh, wait, I used my
We can just get regular Megalovania. I'm sure there's an extended version of it.
We can use one of the other ones too.
Yeah.
Like, game theory version.
Theory trussle, what?
No, you have to get the Megalovania from Earthbound.
Yeah. So, Rylas, what do you want to do?
Well!
The other Ryla was dual teching with Emmerich, so you still have a regular action, Purple Ryla.
Sis, I really regret this.
I've already used up. In this case, I'm just gonna double move to get to here.
DVA was a mistake.
Okay.
This will have use later.
Jesus.
Otto, Christ. What do you do to Matt Pat?
What do you do to Matt?
Look at his eyes.
Get back here first.
Otto, I have a. Otto, I have an idea. If we resonate together, we might be able to heal everyone on the field.
Oh my god, what?
Could work.
Why?
Try it. So this is a dual tech, I guess.
That pat is the inverse of
Mark. Negative theory,
negative theory,
oh,
Matt
no.
Pat.
Oh, no.
Negative theory,
wait.
Matt Pat.
No, never mind.
If it's worth doing, it's worth doing again.
Wait. It's a Matt failure. It's crit one, so never mind. I was thinking since Otto is an ally, Mr. Dad could give him the 16, but...
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Okay, it's a crit fail.
It is
I'm
a crit fail, though. Yeah, it's a crit fail, so...
So, game theory, it's actually the game theory renaissance.
It's fine. Game three stamina. Next time. Okay. Well, that's all my stuff.
So, Big Kong.
Big Kong, I think you know what must be done.
Way out of ya.
Big Kong in the
hall.
All
of my movement action.
He's going to have to use his movement to get out.
What can I even do from here? I don't think I can do anything, so I'm gonna prepare an action.
So, is there anything
actually,
specific,
wait,
or is,
wait, no. I'm gonna use my talent to attempt to convince Sabini to come back again.
Give me a roll for it.
With advantage, I 13. Say.
Okay, okay. Before we go with the bad luck thing, I'm going to roll for game theory. That's not how it works. Sabini is back on your side, Big Con.
Okay, cool.
Is that technically the first... No, it's not a knockout, it's just a team reassignment.
Also, 13. I'm not even sure if we should do this anymore, but it's like... it's a Tails monkey.
Tails. Every time!
You got it wrong!
Let's see what's the next one.
Oh god, if it's the one I think it is, no.
Let's see, I think that puts you at number 5. Okay, so let me double check the luck thing.
Is it third?
A random enemy has a saved crit fail, so...
Oh... It's either Charlie or Matt.
It's Matt Pat.
Okay, it's
Matt Pat. Oh god.
Okay, so is it Emmerich Ryla?
It's actually... Big Kong can use a beanie now, because
it's true.
Oh, okay! Alright, in that case, move there! Copycat on a beanie to pit Matt Pat!
There you go!
Wolf for pit.
Pit.
Ooh. Okay,
I'm assuming since a beanie has 8 max health, she doesn't take stamina.
Oh, wait, the pit kind of, never mind. Oh, the pit's gonna mess with my detail.
Alright. Mm. Well. Beanie does not take stamina cost.
Okay,
so,
cool.
I'll stick out of it.
Matt Pat's legs fall into a pit.
Oh, is he big enough to still be standing out of it, partially?
He's still standing outside
he's
of it.
He's huge!
Okay, ooh, perfect.
We can only see his torso now.
Alright, so
Emmerich Ryla.
Alright, so Emmerich turns to Ryla, and,
Emmerich, we need to kill this person no matter what.
Yes, and my dual tech plan is actually perfect for it. So you're able to pull out seemingly random items, correct?
Have no connotation of the situation.
Seemingly irrelevant. Irrelevant.
Would a cannon be seemingly irrelevant?
Attack on Matt Pat.
Is a cannon seemingly irrelevant enough?
GM.
Roll to convince GM.
And if Sylvia's doing it, she's next to Emmerich, so +5 because of his passive.
Oh yeah.
If it's cannons are automatically irrelevant.
Oh,
it's all theories.
By all technicalities.
By all technicalities.
Damn technicalities.
So you can get the cannon if you use the ability.
Okay. So yeah, and remember with the ability it is with +5. So Emmerich, as the swarm still. All right. As my swarm, I shall enter the cannon.
You're still the swarm.
Yeah, as my swarm, I shall enter the cannon, and you shall fire me directly into Matt Pat's face.
Good idea.
Okay, so, Lila, give me a +5.
Yeah, there it is, the 16.
So you have a giant cannon.
All right, Emmerich's gonna roll.
Roll for cannonball.
Yeah! Can I add +7 to make it even worse?
Should Happini also participate since she's technically trapping him in a pit?
And hey, if this is technically PvE, does Emmerich gain a proficiency point?
Yes, you can gain a freaking.
Yeah!
Oh god.
You goddamn monster.
Emmerich once again destroying the boss!
This swarm of Lobats is just fired directly into Matt Pat. He takes 15 damage.
Can I use my other 2 7s to do more?
I'd like to try, yes.
I mean, do I have to roll to use the 7s?
A roll to having a 34, you would have to roll a d20 to see if
all you right, can convince me. Alright, Emmerich, go for the double crit! No!
That's a 4 is part of the number 34, so yes, you can.
Alright, Emmerich's gonna dump all of his jackpot sevens into destroying Madcap.
That is down to less than half of his health.
Oh my god, Emmerich.
That hurt.
This is officially the best fucking match.
Game theory! Is MadPat the worst fighter at DBA? I say so! Enemy number one of the Ralavarian Empire! He says, transforming back to normal form.
Save your speech! We still gotta kill Charlie after this!
Was both Ryla and Emmerich's, so yeah. Negative theory MadPat slash Charlie Betts' turn.
Oh. Oh god.
What the hell is going on?
Let's see. Let me think of what negative game theory MadPat is going to do.
Emmerich is in his normal form. It's presumably near him, so just letting you know.
Game theory. Okay. I'm trying to think of the right words. Game theory. Good dipped in butter.
Nope.
Oh no.
Uh-oh.
It's like that one episode of SpongeBob.
Yeah, I know, that's exactly what I was thinking!
a giant fork then comes down and stabs Emmerich for 6 damage.
Ow!
Oh yeah!
Can I shave it with Mr. Dad?
If you would like to.
Okay, so we both would take 3 then. Thank you so much, Mr. Dad. I forgot that was a thing.
Everyone
and Charlie's on MadPat's side, so 1, 2.
Oh god! Wait, that's right!
No!
So.
Do your worst!
God. By the way,
that's right.
Oh no. Machine gun, and he's going to use 3 of the 7s he's accrued to get double advantage on using the ability.
Okay, I'm waiting to see this!
Oh no.
Uh-oh.
So, 3d20.
Charlie, what are you doing, buddy?
Oh
no!
So never mind. Emmerich isn't going to have to sacrifice himself.
Okay, so that's a 3. So he can get 1 effect from his once per combat ability. This is just ignore the roll. This is his ability.
Yeah.
Of course, Charlie's first day back, he has terrible luck. How should I not see this coming?
Well, Emmerich sapped it all.
Emmerich
sapped it match.
What he's going to do is cast Wild Magic on himself with his 3rd ability, and because he rolled so low to activate it, he's going to be stuck with the actual effect and not going to be able to mess with it.
Poor boy. Oh boy.
Roll the 300, gain a new epithet!
Alright, let's begin. It was all a part of my master plan!
88, can anybody get 88 for me?
Yep. That is, target becomes tiny.
Giant MadPat, tiny Charlie. What a wonderful
look over as Charlie approaches and then suddenly. Shrinks.
Shoots himself in the foot and shrinks.
Chip salivates at the polarity.
Anime head tilt.
Jesus Christ, why did I even come back here?
Oh, you're right there.
Sir. Right. Does Hapini also know no soft egg, perchance?
No, Hapini is incapable of learning that.
Shit. Okay, we'll just have to stay
the moves. The moves that Hapini can learn are Pound, Charm, Copycat, Refresh, and Sweetness.
Ooh. Well, let's save the Octonian Resonance for next round. Because we gotta do it together, or else it's not cool.
Are they like the anti is?
Bitch.
Okay, so what's going on? What are you doing?
Trying to pick him up with the Low Dad Claws.
Nope.
It's
He's a bit too small, I'm afraid, and your hands are too big. You can't pick up.
I haven't practiced with these in forever.
Ah, the old Lodad claws.
Yes.
Dad, that you have a saved crit fail
up
to use or whatever.
If I fail on that, I might just knock myself out.
Well, it's Jamie's turn, so...
Do I have to use it by the end of combat, or is that just one that, I have?
It's by the end of combat.
Okay, yeah, let's do it.
Given to you by luck.
Emmerich's just gonna end it.
Okay, I'm just saying for when an enemy is taking an action, you have that for whenever you're gonna use it.
Oh, I can use it on enemies?
I know, crit fails are... If I give you a crit fail as a reward, it's to be used on an enemy.
Oh,
I said that earlier.
No, okay.
Oh. Wow.
All right, Emmerich, well, since this seems like the match now, I guess we'll just have to pick up our duel later.
Oh, don't worry, there'll be plenty of time!
The duel was canceled. Now we are a team.
Let's hit him with my drop kick. Hopefully.
No!
Oh, Jamie!
What?
Okay.
Did you say drop into the hole kick?
No!
So you go over to try and kick him. No, behind Ryla. You score over
or him. Between the Rylas, I guess.
Jamie, you were a little bit overzealous that time!
Sorry!
You okay down there? Need some help?
Because that's a crit fail that it'll take your next turn to get out, I'm afraid.
Alright. Cool. Sorry, I'm not-
Elphanus.
I'm not used to being-
I can't believe I'm gonna try this.
Out of my battle trance.
You know how railguns work, right? Electromagnetic railgun?
Oh god.
Electromagnetic railgun the vending machine into MatPat.
I didn't realize
well.
Venus number 2 was gonna
yeah.
be in this combat.
No! Now that we move to PvE, everyone's unlucky! Because we're all on Big Kong's team!
Holy shit! Well, it is behind me!
And
by myself?
Why did you have to
sacrifice
literally all of our luck
I'm
for that
sorry.
You take 8 damage as the railgun
no,
fires right
no,
into you.
No, she does not! Because Emmerich is going to use exoskeleton safeguard!
One!
No!
Sorry, God.
Oh, God.
Even Emmerich's running out of luck!
Whoa!
Okay. Game theory, DBA is unlucky. So how much damage does who take what now?
What's going on?
I'm trying to figure. Okay, so actually, Jamie was in the pit, so Jamie is out of factor because she was underneath.
What?
Wait, given the path it took, wouldn't it still have hit MatPat anyways?
It just like pokes him a little.
Yeah, it's a nat 1, so it just...
Damn it!
Over.
It wouldn't because he's half in the pit as well.
Oh,
yeah,
damn.
He's a
oh,
bit
well.
Lower.
So how much damage... Just... Because, keep in mind, Emmerich does have the exoskeleton safeguard up, so...
Okay, so Emmerich is going to take 4. Ryla and both Rylas are going to take 4 now.
Emmerich ain't looking good, guys.
Okay, you are still up though, right?
Yeah, I am up, but barely.
Okay. Auto! Dual
Do
tech
you
with.
Want to shave some of it off for Dad.
Yeah. Dual tech with Hapini. Dual tech heal with Hapini.
I know. I'll. Emmerich will take the brunt of that. So.
Okay. Is this dual tech just to like?
Okay, so wait, what are y'all trying to do?
Otto can dual tech with Hapini to heal. Emmerich and Hapini can copycat to heal.
Don't worry, Dad can join to make it a triple tech.
Well, then you have to wait till Dad's here, wouldn't you?
Otto and Hapini, give me heal rolls.
Yeah. What was that?
Otto and Hapini. If Otto and Hapini are doing the dual tech healing, you don't have to give rolls.
Alright.
Yeah.
Was it?
Oh.
Yeah. Ooh.
And Otto gets a
Hapini! Do we have it?
Hapini
do we have
with
a
the 20!
Do we have poke floats?
Okay.
Yeah!
Oh god.
So
the PD gets one proficiency.
Was there,
oh, yeah. Otto does get advantage.
There,
yeah.
Oh yeah, so Otto I guess can roll.
So,
yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're all just like trying to do a group heal over here.
Yeah, Otto
or
and
what?
Hapini are like well, Otto is healing Emmerich and then Hapini is copying that heal to heal Emmerich again.
In that case, Emmerich is going to regain 12 stamina.
Whoa! Oh, much appreciated, Otto and Hapini! I wasn't feeling super good there!
Happini's my favorite DBA fighter.
Bong, are you going to
yes,
that?
Welcome to the Rumble.
Okay, one, two...
I have a very important...
Four! Oh, yeah?
Is negative 30 MatPat considered unholy?
Yes, yes he is.
Most certainly.
Very incredibly.
Okay, I know what I'm doing my next
But you did-
Alright, I'm going to use- Hold on, I need to type the name of my own ability. I'm gonna use Out of Sight to summon a cardboard box to put on MatPat, then I'm gonna try to set it on fire with the free action of the push.
Oh yeah, Otto can move, I'm assuming, as well, yeah.
Wouldn't just use the torch on him in general, but okay.
It's your dad! Quick, give me the 16 for Box!
Sure.
Box on his head, but he's very large right now, so it doesn't really obstruct him that much.
It still is enough to where fire will hurt.
Yeah, it's still on fire!
You can roll to put him on fire. It's a free action, but you still have to roll for it, I'm afraid.
Okay.
Yes!
Also, don't forget to take. Don't forget, for PVE,
Big Bang
has an extra proficiency because 20. So.
Oh, yeah, true. Is it Big Kong or?
It's the proficiency, not Big Kong.
Sorry.
Okay.
I also have
an important question since we kind of skipped my movement there.
Sorry.
Otto's weapon radiates holy energy. Can that do passive damage to MatPat?
Not because of how. Because it's. Holy weapons don't just radiate energy. If we're going by like D&D rules, you have to actually hit them or whatever to get the holy effect.
It says it radiates holy energy, so I say.
Okay, give me a convinced GM roll then.
Achievement unlocked. Unlock super secret super boss negative theory map pad. Have the teams join together and both teams win.
Okay, so I'll say that
I'll say
at the start of your next turn he'll take one passive damage and every other turn after that. And that'll just be an extra effect.
In order to get this ending you had to have the Emmerich and Jamie duel.
Yeah, the Emmerich and Jamie Max social link.
You had to get the special Janie PTSD event.
And the auto drug event is very important.
You have to use the lever you used.
What causes it after getting all of those is throwing Big Kong into a pit, apparently.
So, at the start of Otto's next turn, Game Theory will take a passive holy damage, and at the start of Big Kong's turn, he'll be taking fire damage.
Okay.
Is there anything you want to do?
Emmerich? Okay. Emmerich, getting up after Railgun, feeling much better because of the healing. Again, thank you, Happini and Otto. He's going to turn to Mr. Dad. Mr. Dad, you have the ability to copy other abilities, correct?
Indeed I do.
Well, how about we do a dual tech with double March of the Mollusks?
Alright.
Alright, okay, so Emmerich's pushed back to, Dad. Yeah.
Olivia, your turn.
Sylvia,
favorite gun? Wait, before that, Sylvia, though, if you guys want to wait two more turns, we can make it a triple tech March of the Mollusks.
That we can.
A peeny?
What?
Oh, yes.
Copycat!
I'm okay with waiting.
That'll be a big help.
Yeah, I'm okay with waiting.
Give me a second. So,
oh my god.
I'll move, if y'all want to do that, I can move y'all under to where y'all can do the tri-tech with,
Big Kong.
Yeah. Well, no, it'd be the last time Havini moved, it was, like, pretty much on Otto's turn, so I'd say before.
Okay. I moved him.
Otto.
All right.
I moved him to where it would be. Okay, so, Ryla, it's still your turn.
I'm going to wait until Ryla's turn, so,
So we're gonna recombine
Ryla
then.
Back to Ryla.
Yes.
I can just get you off the turn order then. So it's, y'all just skipped to MatPat's turn then.
I mean, okay. He has to get out of the pit anyway, so...
Yeah.
That's if he wants to get out, and he didn't do that on his last turn is the thing.
Oh...
Game theory. Charlie isn't small, he's tall.
Yeah, game theory, Charlie's actually 10 feet tall.
Take him.
Woo!
Never mind, you know what? I'll just hold on to that one.
Charlie's not small, he's incredibly small.
10 feet!
eight smaller is what you mean!
What happened
like,
to John?
It's like in the movie. Okay, y'all have seen the movie Ant-Man, right?
Yeah!
Shirt's
yeah.
going subatomic, I'm afraid.
Oh god!
Oh no, Charlie.
John, oh god! He's gone!
Charlie's
actually. Charlie's no good, horrible.
For Charlie, with his... He's going to dump his fourth seven because he doesn't care. He's going to try and free himself from this curse.
It's just a black hole.
He did do a film theory on that.
Make it an at one, Dad.
Who has an at one in there?
Make it an at one.
Oh, Mr. Dad can make it an at one.
Remove one of the sevens.
Finish. I actually think I shrunk his icon too small, so give me a second.
Just gone.
Okay, so because he is using, he's forcing his luck to this, he is forcing himself out of MatPat's protection. So he's now back on purple team.
Nice.
Okay.
You went from the announcer to MatPat's ally to our team.
Yeah.
Fuck. Is wrong with this damn tournament.
I love it.
This is the best ever.
Little oh did God. Everybody know, Rio missed one Eldritch Bean after the
closet. Does anybody have a way to help me out of the
entire turn to get out of the hole if you want to get out of it.
Yeah, I don't, none of us are close enough to help you.
Yeah.
Alright, Jamie's just gonna climb out. Alright.
Not that Stezzy Dallas, you will.
Now both Ryla turn can happen.
That's why I gotta stay in bed.
Okay.
Well, looks like we've screwed up pretty badly here.
You make a point,
but I'm pretty sure, yeah, you both screwed up pretty bad. Charlie is steaming. What does he have to deal with this crap?
What should we do about this?
You brought everyone together, and there's nothing to be ashamed about that.
Yes,
for.
If anything, we are now a stronger team.
We summoned the worst demon in the universe.
Well, yes, but we're also a strong team. I'm used to fighting these sort of Eldritch Abominations things that are scary.
I have an idea.
What?
Make
yeah?
Fun. I'm going to make a cross. Roll to summon a holy cross. I'm not gonna
didn't.
Okay. It's a plus 5, it's just a 12.
I summons Jesus to eliminate.
Okay, what was the thing I didn't
why
hear?
Why can't I click anything?
I didn't hear at all. What were you saying?
I'm making a holy cross.
So you pull out a cross.
Launch it with the cannon into his heart.
Yes!
Ryla goes over and pushes and, puts it into the, cannon. And can I roll to, push it, or...?
Yeah, you can roll to readjust it, but I would say that you would not be the one to fire the Ooh. Other Ryla.
Yes, yes, fire. Yes. Yes, I'll fire it, you push.
Now, yeah, give me a 19. Second part. Okay, so yeah, it's perfectly aimed right at him.
Steady. Aim.
Ryla, give me a firing shot.
And fire.
Please.
Rolling d20.
Please don't. Oh. Thank God it's not a nat one. Jamie does.
Yeah.
So, us is not supposed to be in.
Oh wait, Mr. Dad. Worry. Mr. Dad, does that work?
Did you say 13?
Oh boy. Okay,
sure,
so before we go,
team.
If you can fire again, give us a chip count.
It's a tails.
I'll guess tails.
Alright.
Oops.
You know, Charlie's not in the announcer's booth. Is he even on the coin?
Oh, that was the canon joke that happened. It's just the coin. It's just Charlie and Chip.
Yeah.
Okay, so he called it wrong, right?
Yeah. Yep.
Seventh effect, which is,
oh no,
it's on the enemy team.
What's on the enemy
oh,
team?
Oh no,
Chip is now on.
No,
no!
Oh, no,
Chip, no, don't go to the dark side.
Don't you actually oblige with you.
No.
Chip.
It's fine. I can work with this.
Ryla.
No, don't hit me.
Now that that's resolved, Ryla, you can. Ryla, you can re-roll your
cannon. We need an announcer! We need an announcer! At this point, go back to... I just missed Johnny!
Johnny just falls in the hole as he walks.
Patronics.
He just falls in the hole.
Austin,
wait. D20. What?
Give him Austin. A D20.
Oh, roll a D20?
Me?
Please.
Okay.
Wait, who's doing what now?
I'm rolling a d20.
Okay, so, just saying the only thing, if you crit failed, nothing would happen. But they're right, they need an announcer. And you know who's the co-announcer to Brooks?
Oh, no.
Is she? That's
right, Victor!
Oh well, shit! You're right! Should I get her as Victor as a joke?
Okay.
Victor takes off
this
mask.
Because this is bad luck day, Victor is like, oh hey, guys, what's going on? I thought someone called me with all the bad things going on.
Yeah, perhaps one of my magic tricks can help.
Okay, Ryla.
Well, I guess since I have to re- Well, I guess yeah. I re-
Now re-rolling the cannon because of-
Oh!
Of course! As soon as I appear, other people start getting
yes! Funny. Perfect! I have absorbed all of the bad luck!
Yes!
We need-
Do we get the Ryla theme?
Yes!
Oh yeah, I was not gonna play because we keep on-
Here we go.
It.
Okay, it's all
Matt
now.
Pat says, Fury! The cannon doesn't work! Forget about it!
Okay, give me a second. Because
Matt Pat says it.
Nah, just yes. Joking.
He is like an anytime, and he can use it like once per round or whatever. So it's he's going to use his action to try his best. Game theory, this pit is deeper!
Deeper than you
so
think.
That way he...
Oh!
I don't think so. That's a one.
It's a 19, isn't it? Oh, wait, no!
Nice.
The cannon is fired. It freeze frame. Game. Mad Pat makes it smaller. Mr. Dad snaps his finger, and he's. The world activates. Time is frozen. Charlie activates his stand. The world. In a freeze frame, the cross's fire is like halfway to Mad Pat. Mad Pat was in the middle of digging himself deeper in the hole. You know, because he's Mad Pat. That's just what that is. And Mr. Dad is then using. Because of flavor, Mr. Dad then uses Otto's ability to push the floor back to even. So he's going to take the attack full on.
And afterwards, can Emmerich and Dad follow up with March of the Ultimate Mollusk?
So, freeze frame unstops.
Yes.
And gets hit. Let me subtract.
Yeah, subtract the damage. We need to bring this man as negative as possible.
Just an army like
Wait,
thousands of vampire lobsters, dad lobsters.
Hello.
He's at one.
Ooh. Okay, so first off, that's a 7 for Charlie, and he's at one. Yes.
Okay.
Nice.
Turn.
So let's have a look at these rolls, shall we?
Oh wait, he's at one, and Otto does a passive 1 damage.
Oh. we gotta overkill him. We can't just let him sit here.
Yeah. He's only staggered at the moment.
Yeah.
Oh.
Okay. He's.
It's like the one boss is an RPG where once you get them down to 0 health, the battle freezes. They push you super far away so that they can try to heal.
Watch out! He's up to something.
This is Kingdom Hearts now.
I want to hold my action to make a quadruple attack to use Chain of War Plan to accelerate the Lobats.
Hey, how about we do a team tech together and think of some
yes.
Oh boy.
Yes!
Yes!
Okay.
If that's the case, Chip is going to take his action against you because he's also in this combat.
Yeah, I know. Okay.
We're just ignoring him.
Yeah,
so,
and then,
okay, so here's what's going to happen. Everyone says what they're going to do to help this team attack, and then Chip is going to do whatever right. he
here's,
wants.
Here's my proposal.
Oh,
my
man.
Proposal is Big Kong summons the biggest box possible, blinds either Chip to stop his interference, or MatPat just for kicks. Otto and Jamie, Otto using the floor, Jamie kicking MatPat up, launches him into the air. Emmerich, Happini, and Dad go into the cannon, which the Rylas fire, and Charlie uses his luck in order to expand its power.
And then yes. we just low bat suplex him.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
So everyone give me a d20 for your part of the plan.
And remember, anyone adjacent to me is +5!
Yep.
Woo! Jamie!
No, Emmerich!
Okay, so this is...
I got 20! Yeah! Oh shit, I got a roll for Happini!
Oh, boom.
What the hell happened? Hey,
Happini! And Charlie gets a +5 to hit, so it's a 23.
Ryla, the Ryla that I control, is also going to use a surprise tool that will help us later to summon... Can I summon an ultra-powerful AI?
You should summon the Pope.
No.
Yes. Summon the Pope.
Summon the Lord
Pope. It's supposed to be a small thing. I don't even remember why I let you grab a cannon. I forgot about that.
Well, it happened already. Well, it technically already happened. Too late.
Yeah, I know.
Can I make him ultra-powerful computer?
Roll for it.
Yeah, an ultra-powerful computer for anyone on the stream that couldn't hear it because she's real quiet.
I'm going to get a computer.
James, you get James Invisible's laptop.
Can I use the wiki game?
Do
wiki
it.
Game?
No.
Do it. Do it. Do it.
Yes. Do it.
Mark Dayton appears and gets hit by your trampled by
the
Lobat.
Just another day in the life of Mark.
Oh, please don't be Mark.
Negative theory, MatPat. I think you mean negative bullet. Politics, Mark Dayton. Because he recently left it.
So, for some reason...
Health abomination.
For some reason, this thing has, like, Wikipedia on it. Let me just, huh.
Furball, the video game.
What?
It's a platform game developed by software.
Video game? This is MatPat's strength. He's going to get a passive game theory roll based around this.
No, he's... No! Yes!
No!
Yes!
Ooh, nice. He's too distracted by the fact that you kicked him into the air.
Theory is automatically disproven by the creator.
Alright, team! Let's go!
So,
yes!
There is now a giant cat in here as well.
Just to further accentuate how anime is.
Yeah.
Jamie just like, not talking, just completely focused, just boots MatPat into the air with 15.
Otto helps with that by pushing the ground up from underneath him with a.
He takes out his stand, Johnny Cash, and ora's MatPat.
Emmerich looks to Mr. Dad. All right, Dad, let's go. As they.
Oh, by the way, Chip is gonna all in Emmerich's role.
Oh yeah. Oh okay.
So heads or tails.
Oh, heads or tails. Let's go with tails.
Okay.
Come on, Emmerich.
Come on.
It's
tails. Yes.
It's a crit.
Oh, let's play the. Can we play the Dad and Emmerich dual theme? Because it's jazzy as fuck.
Do
okay,
it.
Give me a second.
Do it.
Yeah. What even was this combat?
All right, Dad, let's go.
All right, Bat Dad, ho or.
Oh wait, give me a second while I roll for the cat's attack against MatPat.
Yeah.
Wait, where did he go?
What did Hapini do? Can Hapini?
Oh yeah, Hapini was also part of the Lobats.
Hapini was also part of the Lobats.
Yeah. The cat kind of scratches at him.
I rolled the 20 for firing it.
Oh, yeah.
You did.
So, this just freaking... It's not even a little bad swarm anymore. It's like a...
It's a storm.
Like, you know how... what's the word? Not scarab beetles. You know that other Egyptian insect?
It's like wishy-washy.
Locust.
Black silk sky.
It's not a swarm of Lobats. It's like it is a swarm of Lobats, but it's just not in the shape of
a plague of Lobats.
It's like an actual swarm,
yeah,
like a American style of Lobats. You all drag him down the pit, and the pits, as we all know,
drag him back to hell where he belongs.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh god. This floor is a direct portal to hell, so you drag him right back down to hell.
Emmer gets
hey! It. How's it going, buddy?
Back, foul beast!
Hey,
welcome
Doc.
Welcome back.
It's just, you know, a regulation, a theory.
Now it's everyone versus Chip.
As Emmerich does this,
everyone's turn goes through, and it's, let me add. Chip, just give me a roll to see what turn you're at.
Yeah, while Chip is doing the roll, I like to imagine as Emmerich is doing this, he gets a flashback of Big Kong. Somehow this finisher seems familiar.
I don't want to do this anymore.
We're going to reset combat, except for Chip is now at the top of turn order.
So that means I have Rock Lobster again, right?
Technically, yes!
I just meant initiative. But
technically, yes! Said it, so technically it is!
I was trying to say technicalities.
Technicalities!
You're
punching me again.
I don't want to do this!
So, for turn.
Wait, if he's at the top, auto go believe him.
Okay.
Because then everyone would kill him beforehand.
You're about to see the most one-sided murder in your entire life!
No!
It'll be the greatest spectacle besides one of my magic shows, that is.
Guys, don't kill me!
I mean, we're not the ones doing it, Chip. Go get him, Slugger, I'm sure you can.
Don't worry, I locked the door to the tower.
Okay, well, I guess then Chip is gonna try and, all or nothing his size. I don't know, and durability, you know?
For it.
Chip gets fucking murdered by him.
Nope.
Oh, no, Chip.
Charlie looks at Chip and he sighs as Chip begins to shrink as well.
No. Chip's gonna all or nothing that. Chip's gonna all or nothing that. Sorry, all in.
So you manage. As you start shrinking, you use your anytime and you just go back to normal size.
Wait, I've gotta roll.
Yeah, the 1d2.
Odds. Sorry.
Oh, what if Chip just is subatomic now?
What? Yeah. If I fail, this is it. Yeah. Oh, wait. Oh. Whoops. That was wrong. Sorry.
You picked odds, I think, right?
Odds. Okay. So it's a good success.
Come on!
I'm for something.
My friend!
Guys, come on! It was just a prank!
I don't really like videos.
I thought rigging the fight would be funny!
Oh god.
Chip, yes. All you have to do to avoid this is step out of the arena.
Surrender!
I can't step out of the arena.
He can!
Just let me lose.
It's Chip's turn. Big Kong, and give me a second while I give Charlie a turn, because he was supposed to be on Mad Pat's turn.
So
I'm just
going to
stick him
Chip
in as 7.
I'm going to summon a bit under his other leg.
Roll for it.
He's sweating profusely.
A pit under his other foot, but it's not gonna take as much to get out since he has a giant leg.
Ah!
Oh god. Why did I end up being the fucking PvE boss?
You were
Happy he's gonna use copycat and summon more pits under chip.
No,
give me the roll for it.
You know these pits.
Was a pit under his other both legs. A penis creates a pit between both pits, dragging him completely into the pit.
Oh, perfect!
So, because of the original pit's effect, Chip's next turn will be skipped on ticking out of here.
If he has a turn, because it's Emric, correct?
So, Emric, your turn.
Rock Lobster! Come on, that's not a 20, Emric!
Rock Lobster.
Okay, give me a second while I copy the other lobster.
My god. This is beautiful.
And because Chip is trapped, he can't even try to get
guys,
away from
go,
this.
Oh wait, wait. Oh,
not the lobster!
Oh boy! Is Mr. Dad able to copy it or no?
This is his last stamina. This knocks him out.
Okay, so...
Mr. Dad!
Dad!
He doesn't take like a man.
Oh, wait. Oh,
he already did on turning into a Lobat swarm there.
Dad is trying to make another rock lobster is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay,
because
you don't actually get double the effect, but you get the regular effect.
Yeah.
Nice.
Someone tell my family I love them.
Take 14 damage from the combined rock lobsters.
Chip gets fucking murdered by the gang.
Steps up. I try and find the Donnie Cash icon because he's going to summon his stand.
Oh no!
Yes!
Charlie, wait! We're not somebody's right.
Oh, Charlie.
Victor looks, Victor looks to Brooks. We're the announcers now, buddy.
Which means we're the new final boss.
Boss rush. You gotta get through all of it now.
Charlie, Charlie, final boss. Chip, I don't like it when you rig my slaughtery.
Announcer
hey,
boss.
Wait a second, guys. I was supposed to be an announcer during this card game. Do
leave,
I count?
No.
I am going to
no. Get that thing out of here.
No.
I'm trying to find the thing, and I can't. I'm gonna go for another arena, see if it's on that one.
Yeah, while you're doing that,
the
just...
The good news was done, and Fusio was around.
Leave! He was in hell! He got dragged there with that.
They're both in hell! Too bad! I managed to escape while the pit was open!
Oh, shit!
Oh, no, there we go! I'm back!
You just hear from seemingly nowhere. Would you mind sending him back down here for me?
We aren't summoning another boss.
Wait, Sylvia, are you in GM mode? Because I think you're the one that uploaded Johnny Cash.
Get rid of Donny Fuse. Oh jeez.
Okay. So Sylvia, were you the one that uploaded the asset for Johnny Cash?
The first, but not the second.
Just upload it now, or you can just make it a token or what. I mean, if you scroll through your recent uploads or whatever far enough down, you'll find it.
I do not know that
portion. This is going to be. So while we wait for the stand to actually be summoned.
So.
That's close enough, I guess.
That's enough! Shoddy cat!
No, not the eyes!
So
not
who's gonna
eyes.
Try and get everyone together to do an announcer boss rush?
Yeah.
It's good enough. Johnny Cash is going to stand rush Chip.
No! Not my eyes! The drumsticks!
Okay, Chip takes 4 damage, but also wild magic because that's Johnny Cash's ability.
Oh, come on!
Roll wild magic.
You
is already dead.
I should have never. I mean, I should have never gone this far. This truly is the worst.
The target can now move twice as many spaces, so long as they do the ninja run.
Yep. He's under two lobsters.
Conscious.
Under two lobsters and all. Alright. I'm really sorry about this, Mr. Chip, but I gotta do this.
You don't have to do this.
I do.
Oh, come on.
No, she doesn't. Never mind.
Into the hole she goes.
It's nice in here, at least.
She gets up next to Big Kong.
1 second. Is it Ryla's turn?
Yes, it's Ryla and Ryla.
Sorry, I'm not really feeling it. You're right, Mr. Chip, I don't have to.
Wait, I'll launch you forward. Launch you forward so you can go wherever the hell you want.
No,
I guess.
Ryla, don't worry, I have an idea. Roll to
what?
Pull out gun. Roll to, roll to shoot Chip in the head.
That's really relevant there.
But I didn't catch it.
Ryla wanted to gun.
Yeah, I take out a gun and shoot Chip in the face.
By the way, okay. Chip is looking terrible. So.
Yeah.
Wait, I have what you pull out? You pull out Chip's gun. Give me a
d6. Oh. Nerd bullet!
That's not a
d6. 20. 6.
One.
Is that the nerd bullet?
It's a nerd bullet.
That's the nerd
bullet. Okay.
Oh my god.
It pokes Chip in the eye.
Is that gonna hit Chip, do you think?
Okay.
Wow.
Can you tell me what your gun's stats are or whatever?
It nerf bullet just does 1 damage.
Yeah, but like, what's the range?
I wasn't expecting.
Is it more than? Is it 10 feet?
Ah, there it is. Yeah, it's 3 range. So yeah, 15 feet.
Well, wow.
Knocked out, but I'll allow him to use his compound coins as he wishes.
As oh yeah, he has 7 compound coins. Oh,
well,
geez.
I still have an action too.
Yeah, that's true. It's
I'm
not his turn then. So.
Well, I'm going. Well, climbing on the camera. This will be really bullshit.
We're
going to climb on the camera, electromagnetically launch it up, and land it on, and then land it on.
Well,
yes, this is bullshit. But
just saying, Gecko's is going down. I just want him to have some fun too. He can use his compound coins.
You know, how about, Chip's just like, if I'm going down, I'm going down with fireworks!
And, so he has 7 compound coins. He's gonna burn all of those in a wild magic affair!
Oh, oh god.
Post your thing, which allows
Chip
you to
summons most Avery's house!
Yes!
On top of himself!
Okay.
So everybody gets wild magic.
Oh, everybody!
Everybody gets wild magic.
All
okay,
of these.
Okay. So what? Right,
so which ones are for who?
Who's for what?
It doesn't matter.
It's, I think all 7 is against everyone. I'm not sure how it works.
Jesus Christ!
Oh God!
Don't know about that.
All right. Post all of them.
God. Sorry about that.
No, it's fine, just...
I just figured
fine,
Chip
dead.
Would want it to be like this.
Then
yeah.
Charlie's like, oh
it's
hey, a 7.
Talking must speak as if they are through. They are in a presidential debate. For the rest of combat, everyone's the next presidential elect.
This has been the presidential
Alright, change the favorite character poll to who is the president poll.
And we're gonna make the bananas pay for them!
Call from their frustrated grandmother, and they have to talk to their grandmother as though they're in presidential
Everyone! What the
Even
hell?
Oh my god.
The end of it.
Grandma, please vote for me.
That's irrelevant to this situation.
No, Grandma, I told you. I'm gonna repeal gun rights.
Grandma, I told you. I'm going to strengthen gun rights.
Grandmother,
Grandma,
I told
listen,
you.
I said
died
I'm
in
going
the year
to make gambling.
That water is poisonous.
I told you. I'm going to make gambling legal, not illegal. Come on.
I'm telling you, grandmother, when I get control of the world as its president, many fair laws to be.
Jesus.
Oh, and then Sylvia's drinking their fizz.
Why not?
Just do it.
Ah, fuck! That's disgusting!
As Chip goes, he, like, throws his compound coins, like, everywhere, and they all stick
terrible knockoff of everyone's favorite anime campaign character.
Terrible knockoff.
Well, I mean, we already have knockoff Giovanni, because Victor's here, so...
California Slim!
Valentine.
Yeah, Vincent Valentine's here.
What about the 237 for Sylvia's drink?
Oh, wait, what?
Uh-oh.
Is that they got forever ago.
Oh, right.
Oh, my God.
Oh, this is the worst timeline.
This was the best and the worst combat.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
We keep summoning people.
It is over. This is just the after effects.
There are so many fucking layers!
What the hell just happened?
Like, the battle changed every turn!
The ride
Rylan
never
ends. Never summon me again, okay?
I can't believe Chip is fucking dead.
I don't know.
So, what happened? This is technically PvE.
Well, I guess if you're gone,
let me think of
then.
What I want the upgrades to be. You can get either 3 stamina or 1 proficiency, because y'all destroyed that combat.
I'll take 1 proficiency, Austin! Does 19 get Big Kong anything new?
Let me check. Let me go to the Banana Slam page.
Well, this is an interesting match, to say the least.
Yeah.
Doesn't get her anything, but she's
this
taking a proficiency.
Alright, so...
Truly.
Yeah, a travesty, but the best kind. Do we want to get some,
yeah.
Do we want to get some music as we,
Early.
Working on it.
What kind of music you want?
Ooh, can you play Auto's theme?
Oh yeah, let's go with Auto's theme!
We're gonna put on screw around music.
Belial, can you help carry me up from hell?
Oh yeah, sure. Hold on.
So Chip just like,
you know, I think I've realized Jamie only rolls good on attacks when she's not like trying to talk and be social.
Oh yeah. By the way, I'll tell you, Dream. I'll tell you, Dream. 19 does not get Big Kong anything according to his old proficiency upgrades.
Damn.
So
I'll give Emmerich 3 more stamina for his PvE shit.
Yeah.
I'm going to give Charlie 3 stamina.
I'm
going to
play it. Yeah, sure, why not?
Well, I guess I'll take 3 stamina as well.
Actually, you know, I'm going to take away that proficiency then and give him 3
stamina. Edis, do remember, this stamina is for PvE only,
yes.
So if you're in a PvP, it's going to not
and
about
And actually, what? On that point, for Emmerich, because, how many 20s did I roll once it shifted to PvE 1?
Since it shifted to PvE, you rolled like 2, I believe.
If that's the case, I get 4 more proficiency because he's an expert Monday.
Jesus oh my Christ. God, Emmerich, you monster!
He's gonna make it to 100 in no time.
He's at 39.
Electronic band.
God, why is Emmerich the new Trixie?
Why is Emmerich the new...
He's at 39?
He's at 39 for PvE.
Oh God. Yeah,
what's his normal proficiency?
His normal is 26! He's got
anything
so many 20s!
Patronix, have you written anything for Emmerich or no? So he's gone through 13 proficiency and unlocked nothing for
him. I gotta give him something at some point.
Fucking, if you think that's ridiculous, Gizmo in the 1 PvE we had got 10, or no, it was either 10 or 6 proficiency.
I think it was 6, yeah.
Alright.
It was stupid.
I do not believe that there was any fan art, but that's okay because we had a good time.
Yeah. I'm looking at
that was awesome.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna get the character poll. The presidential election.
The presidential.
I have a headache now. You guys are.
Sylvia, we switched characters by accident.
So sorry, Ballast.
We switched icons.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Ballast. But...
I can't believe Ryland turns into PvE.
It started out fine, but then Austin was able to get the jackpot, which I didn't even think was going to happen in general. I just thought it was fun flavor text.
Emmerich, what
Freaking three correct guesses in a row.
Oh my god.
Matt Pat is considered an unholy being. Matt Pat is coming up as a boss at some point during my PvE.
Well, yeah, whenever we get the PvE, when the gang goes to hell, he
hell,
can be there.
You're gonna have to come up
with excusable gained 10 proficiency from the one PvE.
Yeah, no, when the gang goes to hell, coach him. Bring in Twist.
PvE combat of versus Matt Pat, Don Fusio, and Alan.
We had far too many characters that could just break everything.
Yeah,
we did break everything. This game was irreparable from the start.
We had like four characters, one that could move twice, that could break and change the rules at any point.
Okay, I want to mention something real fast.
Yeah.
I have actually continue. I'll
okay. Oh, okay.
Yeah, if you guys didn't see it, I did put the character poll in the rule talk, just in case anybody didn't see it.
Yeah.
Oh,
God,
thank you.
This is crazy. Jesus Christ, Emmerich, what the hell?
I'm so sorry for ruining your combat balance.
Honestly,
Emmerich is a monster. I expected something because I was like, you should bring in Emmerich because his luck will be fun for this. And of course, I thought you would have taken that as a hint of sorts that this was a luck based thing.
I think Emmerich should be banned from all DBA.
I did as a hint, but like, I didn't know what because like you were. I figured like a role's being swapped for certain people or like what's going on.
I think. Emmerich should be banned from all PvP!
As we're going on, I forgot to actually keep track, so there were several ones that didn't get actually used because I skipped them out. I was like, oh, yeah, sure, they've been gone, even though they hadn't. But it was just the inverse of the luck effects, basically.
Yeah.
Alright.
Alrighty,
Oh my god, I'm gonna have to change my reaction fields for a few characters.
Yeah, same.
Oh no.
Wow.
Finally
to Chip. I'm sorry I had to punch you with my stando.
Yeah.
Chip.
I just like the fact that Emmerich has gained 13 proficiency in DBA but has not had a single upgrade because I have been too lazy to write them. I feel like I'm gonna give him proficiency upgrades.
Charlie,
I'm gonna give him.
That's why Charlie just got 3 stamina because I've been too lazy to write his upgrades.
Well, yeah,
as well.
No, I gave him 3 stamina, but because he's an expert, Bundy, he had rolled so many 20s.
My God.
And because of that, I feel like I'm gonna give him just something from what he's gained thus far. I don't know what, but.
Can we purposefully create a PvE based one? Like it's actually going to be like whatever the. Zanz is. I don't think Emmerich is in the quest to kill Johnny.
No,
negative plan,
not.
Johnny,
he's
is he?
Not.
No, good.
He has nothing against negative plan, Johnny.
And an actual purposeful PVE that starts as a PVE. Emmerich is going to like break the combat with us. How advanced his stats have become already?
I'm gonna post this in general as well. Of the DBA chat, just to give it a couple more minutes before we show off the final results of the character poll, because obviously,
that was amazing.
It was a big fucking catastrophe, but it was the best catastrophe ever.
Oh my god,
amazing catastrophe!
I had a great time.
God.
Me too.
If you couldn't tell,
I'm just glad that I managed to get into the RP after. Going through the last through the D&D that I was playing, that I managed to enter the RP when Matt Pat was entered. That way, I could actually have him in this and not be like, "What the hell are you guys?"
Yeah, Matt Pat was a thing in the pre-game RP session to any viewers watching the VOD. So, yeah.
Is the game over?
The game is over. Yes,
it was the best.
Yep.
And the worst.
It was something.
As Dante said,
a lot
this truly
more
is
interesting than I expected.
As
to be
Dante
honest.
Said, this it truly is the worst timeline.
Aw, yeah.
Oh,
man. God.
Can you see now why I have so much fun playing Emmerich compared to other characters?
Because,
yeah,
okay, so...
Yeah.
I was actually hoping that you would bring in Rose whenever I was talking about the thing.
Yeah, I know! I know that's what you were looking for, and that's why I brought Victor.
Give me the explanation.
Yeah,
okay. I made a quick shitpost.
Do you know who co-commentates with Brooks? Yeah, it's Victor, my buddy!
Anyway, yeah, alright, yeah, go Ballast, Ballast, go, yeah.
I can't remember exactly, but I think because this was when Chip had just entered combat, I think what Rose was going to give Chip pity and drag him out of combat.
Oh,
no!
I put something in fan art.
Oh, you put something in fan art?
Rose and Rose are two different people.
Oh
no! I'll show it, but thank you, Gecko,
oh, no.
But it's horrible.
No.
Oh god.
Oh god!
No.
Oh,
what happened at the end of this game?
It was the best, you need to see it,
yeah.
And the worst, but yeah.
It caused a chain reaction that was terrible.
It was
the
worst,
wait, who?
The best.
Ryla summoned something, and it went to shit after that.
It was the best.
It
was amazing.
Oh my God.
So, because Ryla summoned something and it was such an evil force that certain alliances had to be made.
Was it Matt Pat?
Yes!
It was Matt Pat! It was Matt Pat!
And then Matt Pat dragged Charlie Betts into combat, and then a few rounds later, Mr. Dad pushed Chip into Matt Pat's side.
It was the worst. Best thing ever.
And then we dragged Matt Pat to hell.
Yeah.
Oh, literally.
I can't wait to see it. Yeah. I'm glad that Ryla had a good
It was a masterpiece.
Oh my god.
This was beautiful.
That started as, it's so unfair. They got Imric on their team. And then it ended with, let's send Matt Pat to hell.
To hell.
Yeah.
Oh wait, this is fine. Now we have Emmerich on our team.
Yeah.
We're all on one big team.
And speaking of all of us being on one big team, bada bing bada boom, hey look, it's the character poll! Woo! Alright, going from bottom to top, we got...
And also, after this, I'm going to be adding Matt Pat to the character relations.
No!
Yes!
Oh, yes!
Okay.
Oh,
God. From bottom to top, Mr. Dad, then tying in third place each with one vote is Big Kong, Otto, and Jamie. Second place is Emmerich Ralivar, and first place with four votes is Ryla Morax. Congratulations, Ryla.
This is the wrong
thank
character
you.
Pool. It's Ryla and Ryla question mark.
Yeah, right.
Ryla's.
Featuring Dante from the Devil May.
Yeah, featuring Dante from the Banana Slamma series.
Oh god.
You might as well have been in that combat.
Anyways, I hope you guys had as much fun watching this fuckscape for National Tabletop Day as we did.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, I completely forgot about that.
This is our contribution. This is our contribution.
Now that I remember that,
the unlucky little
yeah. Big Kong has Dante's codec number. I could have called him.
Oh no, you got him! No!
No!
Oh god.
Realized, because this is National Tabletop Day, there was a dual tech that should have happened where... Remember, y'all have seen T.I., right?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Should have entered the tabletop position.
Oh god.
Tabletopper.
Matt Pat was already in the
position. I mean, if someone else entered the tabletop position, he could have... kicked them.
yo, guys, if Matt Pat creates a theory for Tabletop Day, we'll all say that we were there first.
Yeah.
Yes!
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 Yeah, and, oh man, this is a wonderful contribution. So, I hope all of you guys enjoyed this fucking shit show.
Awesome! The shit show isn't over for the two of us. Now we gotta go.
We'll get to that. But to all you guys on the stream, again, one last time, hope you enjoyed it. I'll post the link to Fine Dining, our Discord for anything on this channel related to D&D, once more in the Twitch chat. So if you're interested in anything else that's on the channel or more DBA news, go there.
Thing that didn't happen that I had planned was if the jackpot was the triple effect. So if you got the jackpot with Charlie, he summons two card clones. Chip, if you got three negative effects all at once, then it's house wins. The consequences are tripled. So you should be glad that never happened, because I wasn't keeping track of Chip's things, to be honest.
Yeah.
Oh, we're all, what the heck?
We're dancing. It's our victory dance.
Yeah.
It's the Kirby dance.
Yeah.
Except Chip is just like a dead body flopping around.
Did someone say dancing?
Oh, God.
Oh, God.
The whole
house back down to
Ryland. Did somebody say tigers?
I can't believe it. So Victor gets dragged into this.
Ryland, yeah. This was a mistake.
All right,
this was a mistake.
Yeah,
yes,
before,
yes, it was.
Before we just drag literally every character from DBA.
Before we end this, yeah. Victor should try and do a magic trick.
Okay. Let me get a sheet.
Good luck magic. Bad luck magic trick.
Let's see if he can do it first. I'm
going to target with your trick, by the way. It is an important thing.
Okay, I'm gonna target. Hey, Brooks, get over here.
Okay. I don't see how this could go wrong.
Alright, I'm gonna say that works. So, I gotta get Victor's sheet up, so let me get. Hold on.
I'm sorry, did you say crit or fail?
Okay. Odds are even, Austin. Odds are even.
Give me an even.
Okay.
And that's one number three.
It is Victor. However, I have.
That's a 1d2. That's not a 1d20.
Oh.
Today.
So we end with Victor failing yet again.
But just
No! He rolled a 1d2, not a 1d20.
Yeah, it technically doesn't specify 1d20.
It counts as a crit fail.
Yeah, and on that. And no, but.
Sorry.
Kicks.
Getting about it.
Just for kicks, I want to see if Victor had succeeded, what trick he would have done, and if it was Tiger.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Just say it didn't work.
No, it's fine.
The beast within me.
No, it's fine. I just want to see 1d10. 4. I don't think that's it. It's the one where he places a hand, basically kills them for a second, then revives them with 4 extra stamina. So Benny dies and comes back.
So Victor is trying to put a hand on Victor, and then Brooks yells at him and causes him to just stop.
Well, shit.
Oh, I was thinking he did, like, the die part, but then just forgot the resurrection, and Benny's dead for
him. Anyways.
God.
All right.
Oh,
say goodbye to chat, everybody. This has gone on long enough.
True.
Goodbye,
chat. This is a fucking shit.